Howdy, howdy. Welcome in, everybody.
Carlos, it wasn't you. Sorry.
Okay.
Welcome in, my guests, Steve, Joy, Tina, and I'm innuendo.
Woo. I am an innuendo.
I think you meant incognito.
No, I didn't mean incognito. I meant everything I say, even my innuendos.
I think you can't really see real good.
Even his camera's blurry.
My camera's blurry?
Yeah.
What?
Can I jump in?
Is it really?
No, you're all right. He just got smudges on his. Yeah, you're good.
Oh, okay.
Welcome in, everybody. Let's welcome in the chat because it's popping.
Why does my wife still have Valentine's stupid things on with this dumb blanket?
Remind you how I'm much sorry. You love her.
Exactly.
I'm sorry.
Hang on. I got to get to the top of the list. Y'all, hang on. I was working on stuff. Good grief. There's a lot of chat going on. Welcome in, Janice Disney, Kenneth A., Nicole Happy Font, Stacy Rogers.
I don't even know what she said, but you do.
She said it's still February.
Still February.
Debbie Bernfeld, welcome in. Sparkly Pink Diamonds, hello, Angie. Good to see you. Jennifer White, hello, hello. Mike Beachman's here. Good to see you. Let's see. Scroll on down. We got Jen S. We got Movie Mania Nick. Welcome in.
I can't say that. I just wanted to.
Tippity doo, Doug. Howdy, Doug. Good to see you. Joy S is here and here. Hello, Joy. Okay, Willie, welcome in. There goes my voice. Tigger Jeff Sean W. Welcome in. Good to see you. We got Fredo Malley's here. Jason Thibodeau, welcome in. Good evening. Spaceship Ears. Hello, hello. Good to see you, John. Scroll on down.
Okay, he's making me a little uncomfortable.
I wear two fingers instead of one, like Walt would do.
Yep, that's why.
Mandy V, welcome in. Jay Nashville, good evening. Good to see you. Emery Dreyer, welcome in, Emery. We got Jennifer White. We got Chris Dye, welcome in, buddy. Good to see you. I'm scrolling. Jennifer White, scrolling. Kay Wilby, welcome in. John K, good evening. Welcome. Good to see you. Scrolling down. Debbie Thunert is here. Welcome in, Debbie. Good evening. Amy, AJC Magic TV. Welcome in, Amy. Disneyland fan. Welcome in, Murph. Welcome in, Murph. Appreciate the help Wednesday as well, Murph.
That's awesome.
We're getting there, y'all. I promise. We got Murph. We got Tina McNeil's here. T. Marie's Place. Both T's are here.
Double T's.
Yep.
I like double T's.
Suzanne. Hey, Suzanne. Justin Sanudo. Hello, you lovely, lovely man. Mr. You're Adorable.
You're sexy. Thank you.
Julie McCallan, welcome in. And there she is. The lovely, the beautiful, the talented, the snicker to my doodle, the snickerdoodle, the angel to my
I'll stop waving until he's done with this, because that,
yeah, that's what I always take a break here too.
Yeah, go ahead.
The angel to my Stitch.
Yeah.
The Rapunzel to my Flynn.
My bad. Carry on.
The Boston cream to my I don't know.
The cream to my filling.
There we go.
That one.
Thank you. Angela Mentor. Hello, dear.
Hi.
We're done. Okay.
We're moving on. Jennifer Caruso, welcome in. Chris S, good evening. Welcome. Good to see you. We got Justin. We got I'm gonna skip over here. Katie Y, welcome in. Genie 52573. Hello. Space Mountain Dave Cantrell, good evening. Good to see you. Mandy V's here. We got Murph. We got What the World with Russ. What's up, Russ? Good to see you, buddy. And Stephen K, good evening. Main Street Nick's here. Streamer Deborah, good evening, Deborah. Hello, hello. Amy K, welcome in. Good to see you. Jennifer, we got Tigger, we got Kay. I think we got everybody.
God. Chris,
we got everybody.
Make sure you say hi to all the Ninja Watchers too.
Hi to all the Ninja Watchers.
Hola.
Hello. Hi, Ninja Watchers.
Pino, never know Pete,
what you're going in here tonight.
Good to see you, everybody. Howdy, howdy.
Hi.
Wow, it's been a week.
Suzanne's already yelling at me. I haven't even said a word yet.
We barely even got the stream started.
Right? And I'm already getting yelled at.
It's okay, buddy.
I know.
It's a support group. We're here for you. Birdwell, 2427, Sandy, welcome.
But we're also here for Suzanne.
That's true, too.
We're here for everybody.
Yes.
That's true. Yes.
Yes.
So, you probably deserved it, Carlos, says Nicole Happy's Honk.
Ooh.
Nicole, I guarantee this time I did not. I can't see you. Can somebody lower the camera, please? Oh, it's not on stream. Oh. Love you, Nicole. Can't wait to meet you in person as I'm spitting pretzel everywhere.
Welcome in, Disnoah's Adventures, Disneyland fan, and Nathaniel Bellis. Welcome in, Nathaniel.
Nathaniel.
Hey. So,
Recap.
Here we go. This week there was a stream on Wednesday.
There was.
It was a very long stream.
There was.
You can't see all of it because YouTube cut it down, but
did they really?
They did. So it stopped recording apparently at 11 hours and 55 minutes, but we went for over 13 and a half hours.
Oh.
So
boo YouTube.
Yeah. If you were here, you enjoyed the extra innings, I guess. But we ended up raising a little over $8,200.
Wow, that was loud, huh? I'm sorry.
For the American Stroke Association, American Heart Association. We raised some more funds last night during Pete's stream. We're up to $8,681 now.
Woo!
The Disney Baker, welcome in, Baker. Howdy, howdy. So the link is still open. DizRN, good evening. Welcome, welcome. The link is still open. We're going to be doing giveaways after a while for everyone that has donated. I will tell you the website shows 95 donors, but there have been 157 separate donations.
Oh, wow.
Very nice.
I've already got the spinny wheel all loaded.
Woo!
Yep. Shelby, welcome in.
In my head.
I'm going to put a challenge out there for tonight.
No. Don't you dare.
Suzanne's already nervous.
Welcome in, Tracy.
If we hit 10 grand tonight, we're not too far. What was the total again, Chris?
$8,681.
$1,329 is nothing for some people. Let's go. I will go outside. It's 10 degrees.
And you got snow on the ground?
I have snow on the ground. I will do a snow angel with a something very small.
Something very small. We don't want to see this.
Nobody wants to see that. Go out there half, three quarters, 90% naked. And do a snow angel. Face down snow angel.
With a snowsuit.
That's what he was
in
wearing.
In the snow, if we hit 10 grand tonight.
Wow. There you go.
We'll do it live on stream. We know you folks have $1,300.
Get the checkbook. Justin says, oh, I want to see it.
Suzanne's got some stuff in there I can put on. We'll go
face down, butt up.
Listen,
face down.
If you're doing face down, you got to do one of Suzanne's bikinis.
Debbie says I want to see this. I think.
No.
And Suzanne says good night all.
What you should have said was $1,300, or I'm gonna do it.
Suzanne, listen. You can't go to bed now because that image is going to stay with you. And then you're going to like see that.
Oh. She's going to see it as soon as I go to bed too, Tracy. So it don't matter.
Ross and Fan wants to know if they can have their donation back.
The only difference is there's no snow in the bedroom.
Welcome in, Mar in Memphis. Good to see you, Mar. And Monorail Molly. Hello, sis.
Molly.
Tina, I'll take all the abuse tonight, sweetie.
Here we go. All right, so there you go. If you want to see Carlos do that, the link is still out there. It's in the description down below. And if you donate, you'll still get your name in the wheel.
There you go. It's a win-win. Win-win. The way it's cold out, you might see me have a heart attack because it's so cold, the heart might stop.
We don't want that.
Well, no, we can get, it can go viral.
You know, some of this is not must-see TV.
Suzanne says, please donate tomorrow.
What's up, people?
Howdy, howdy, howdy.
Very busy week.
Very busy.
Sorry I didn't make it on Wednesday. Hope you had all a good right. stream.
All good. We finished a puzzle and we finished some Legos.
Cool.
Yep.
How'd everybody enjoy the Super Bowl?
It was a game. I didn't get to watch most of it. So,
None of my squares hit. So
the more important thing is tomorrow is the Daytona 500.
Unless it gets canceled.
Well, that's right. That's tomorrow, isn't it?
It is tomorrow.
It'll probably get postponed.
Your favorite person is the Grand Marshal, Steve.
Oh, geez.
Would that really be Dwayne The Rock Johnson?
If you can smell what he's cooking.
Oh, I thought you were talking about the girl version of that.
Oh, you mean Taylor Swift?
Nope.
She's in Australia right now.
Good thing I don't have to watch it because I don't watch racing and the fact Taylor that they're, Swift not, don't smell. They're also not going to race either.
Amy.
Hey, JC. Steve, you have a message in chat.
Free us? Oh. Excuse me. tomorrow. I'm going to free you tomorrow. Sorry.
Tina McNeil says they had a great party.
Talking about a genie?
Genie in a bottle.
Yeah, I worked a double that day, so.
Oh, crap.
Yep. It has to be The Rock because Taylor Swift is in Australia. Yeah, it is The Rock.
What did Suzanne yell? Taylor Swift doesn't smell.
Oh, she does.
Well, she does all right.
Yeah, the cookies like if it's not the other one, it's this one.
Oh.
She doesn't.
Well, that's good for you, Justin. You drank a double on Super Bowl Sunday. That's good.
Yep.
I had no drinking at all.
I didn't watch. Yeah, I got home in time just to see like the end of the fourth quarter. Of course, I guess that's all that mattered since it went into overtime.
So. Yeah. But. Did you see the 100% chance of rain tomorrow?
Yes.
And the 3 inches of rain.
Yes.
Oh.
Here in the
game. There's no race.
The race is not happening.
It ain't happening. I already said that. The race ain't
happening. Well, the Xfinity race got postponed to Monday at 11. So,
yep. Uh-oh. That one's probably going to get canceled to make way for the Daytona 500.
No, they'll probably do the Daytona at what? 9? 7?
Well, they have lots, and they've run that one super late. So,
yeah.
Yep. The Daytona, they'll run late?
Yes. But they could do it Monday afternoon.
Rain, I think.
Justin, those cars don't run in the rain. There's no tread. They've got no tread on their wheels.
What? Wait a minute. Tina McNeil said she had a party for the Super Bowl. And that she ate Jell-O shots. Does that count? Very strong Jell-O shots at that.
Well, yes, Jell-O shots count as drinking.
Rebel.
Look at Tina McNeil go.
In fact, I don't think I've had a beer in about a month.
DizRN says been raining most of the day here in not so sunny Florida.
Yep, that's true.
Yep.
As you can see, I switched to coffee for your streams instead of the beer.
Well, that's good. I prefer water.
I'm Captain Jack. I'm out of rum, but that's okay. I got water that I stole from a guy who has a visor. Drink healthy, drink a lot of water.
I've been missing some water.
Yep. Here you go. Molly says, Molly says she loves The Rock, she loves Taylor Swift, and she loves Travis Kelce.
One out of three is not bad.
Well, Molly, you're worse than Jeff being 100% right 10% of the time. Because you're 100% right right now, 0%
of the time.
Of right now, anyway. All three are so annoying.
Do you think if he would have acted like that during the regular season, he would have actually went back into the game? Kelce.
Oh, yeah.
I didn't see it. Didn't watch the game. Didn't watch.
I think didn't it, watch I think anything. If he would have done that to his coach in a regular season, yeah, he would have been sitting.
Water is healthy for you. Chris proceeds to choke on water. True.
It's true.
Yeah, that happens.
Oh my God. I
can't read that. So yeah, the game was Sunday. The pot roast was Monday night, or should I say the pepper was Monday night with a side of pot roast?
Yes. Pepper yes, roast. It was.
Pepper roast.
Pepper.
I made a reservation for April, Steve. So
Yes.
Even Suzanne's excited to go back for pot roast.
So good.
Is it a Monday? It will be streamed?
It's not a Monday, unfortunately. It's a...
But will it be streamed?
I won't be streaming it. No.
When
is it? It's Friday's Epcot. It's a Sunday. Yeah, it's a Sunday.
She has sexy phone operator voice. Rachel 50 and welcome. Go ahead, Tina.
I was gonna say it's not as bad. It's been worse. No, it's not as bad right now.
But you got some allergies or sick?
No, I'm sick.
But she's sweet cold? Enough to come hang out tonight.
You got a bit of a cold.
I missed you guys.
Yeah, we're know. All here to celebrate your accomplishment on Wednesday.
Yeah.
I will say, I started to make a thank you video, and
are we up to 10 grand yet? Do I have to get ready to go outside?
Yeah. We are not. No, okay. So just wondering. We haven't moved yet, so I don't know what that means, Carlos. Not another dime has been donated yet. So.
They're all. It means they're all afraid of Suzanne, and they're waiting for tomorrow.
There,
if you're new here, my wife is on delay, so it takes a few seconds for the joke to get to her.
Molly wants Tina to say something.
I'm not saying that. Wait, what? Okay, wait, what is it? All right. Can I counter Carlos and say I'll say it if people start donating.
Oh, yeah, there you go. Okay. So it's a twofer.
It's a twofer.
It's a twofer. That's what I'm going to look like when I come out of the snow, a twofer. I don't even know what and I live up here. I don't even know what a twofer is, but we'll look like it.
So, yep.
How did we end up negative, Suzanne? Well,
I'm trying to do my part for your fundraising because one, I wasn't on stream with you long enough. Two, I know Suzanne donated, but I haven't yet. But I'm trying to do my part. What do you call the guy that comes out before the concert? I'm the
fluffer.
No, fluffer. What?
The fluffer.
Whoa.
Got to get the audience ready.
No, that's not what he's called. He's the The hype man. I'm the hype man, but I'm doing it after.
Same thing.
I'm doing it at the fluffer. No, Suzanne. I was about to call you Suzanne. No, Suzanne. You're not fluffing. No, I'm not fluffing anything.
Oh, please stop.
There you go.
I feel a little fluffy, but I'm not a fluffer.
There's the link. I put it back in the chat.
Put it in the chat. Pin it. Pin the comment.
I pinned it at the top.
$1,329. Come on. We can do this.
I don't think Steve's watching the show. I'm not sure what Steve is doing.
Steve's painting.
I'm working on it. What are you? Why? Who? What? What shows am I watching in general? I just got done watching Criminal Record today. And then I was watching Traitors, which is a game show on Peacock. But I'm only second episode in, so don't spoil it.
Oh, before I forget. Hey, Joy.
Hi.
How you doing?
I'm good. How are you?
Good, good, good. Glad you're here.
Joy's been silent because she's texting Justin to not make that donation. Not do it. Because we all know Justin wants to see this. Do not make that donation. We're going to Greece. Cut the crap. We need all the money for Greece. We don't want to see Carlos be a fluffer.
We're up to $8,729.
We're getting there. It's climbing, Suzanne. It's climbing. I know I won't be after, but it's climbing.
They're asking for donations back.
Yeah, I know.
Here we go. So,
sorry.
I don't know what that's. She must have read something in the chat. I can't see chat. But... oh, maybe she just pictured me coming out of the snow. I don't know.
Maybe that's what it was.
A loud outburst for no reason.
She sounds very excited about it.
She does sound excited.
I am not excited at all.
Maybe she thinks the snow will help. I don't know.
Hey, Kenzie.
Is Kenzie here?
Kenzie's here. Nicole wants to know, oh my gosh, why did I look up fluffer?
Yeah, don't do that.
I've never heard it used in the reference that Steve used it in, but I've heard it used in other references. So,
oh, man.
Yeah. Paul Engel, welcome in, Paul. Good to see you. Yeah. Thursday after the stream, I was pretty well wiped out. Like, done. Wiped out. So I finished watching Reacher season 2. I hadn't finished that.
That's so good, isn't it?
It was really good. I kind of liked it better than season 1.
Oh.
Really good.
It's so awesome. It's so cool. Tell me that last episode just didn't give you like closure.
It did, and it made me excited for another season of Reacher.
And they're already filming the third season.
Yeah. That's what somebody else told me. We are up to $8,794. Thank you, Justin. And Kay Wilby. And Tina and Paul.
Kay did it for another shot at the wheel, not for me to go out, Mr. No. So. What? Justin's what? I heard him just now. What's he donating? Oh, is that Jay?
Not a man.
No.
Or it might have been Tracy.
Might have been Tracy because I didn't see it.
What did I do?
I had the chat up, so I didn't see it.
Jeanette Sebastian the Crab, welcome in, Jeanette. Hello, hello.
What did I do?
I was hearing voices and I didn't know who it was.
Dreamer Deborah says, yes, that's another season of Reacher. Sparkly Pink Diamond says, Reacher is a great show. Very nice to look at. I think she means something in the show. I'm not sure she means like the entire show is very nice.
Or any of us.
Yeah. Zanlax, hello. Good evening. I did that Thursday. Watched some of our friends and let's see. Yeah, it's been a week. That's been the week.
Reacher is a great show. You know, there's another one that's out there called Mr. and Mrs. Smith. It's also on Prime.
That one just started. I watched the trailer for that, but I haven't started watching it yet. It looks like sort of a different take on the movie. Mr. and Mrs. Smith.
Yeah, it's a little bit different take, but I think I came across the last episode and it's actually getting more towards like the movie, so.
We are up to $8,821.
Hey, we're on to 1,200. Come on. I'm sure some of you just got your income taxes. Come on, people.
Suzanne is having anxiety. There were a lot of good trailers for new movies coming out during the Super Bowl.
There was. The Moana Part 2. The Return of the Rock.
Yeah. There was Kingdom of the Planet of the Apes or whatever it is.
Looks yes.
Really good.
That was a good one.
So, oh, good grief. We're up to $8,913.
Thank you.
Oh, boy.
That's a thank you laugh.
Did you see the preview for Deadpool 3? Did you watch the trailer on YouTube?
I want to go look for my Speedo. I'll be back.
I did.
What do you think?
I'm really looking forward to this, that movie.
Yeah.
Let's see. I think Deadpool 3 is going to be really, really good. I hope it corrects some of the issues of phase 5 so far. So
then I watched a couple of the breakdowns. There's a couple of channels that do.
Murph says he's on the phone with his credit card company to reverse the charges until tomorrow. Spaceship Ear says my inner geek is unnaturally excited at the reviews for Dune 2.
Got to be better than Dune 1.
I almost watched that the other day.
What, Dune?
Because I still haven't watched the first one.
First one's just a very long setup story.
Well, it's supposed to be a long. I mean, if you've ever read the books, I mean, they're just...
Books and movies are different, though. Movies got to grab your attention, and it's just long and drawn out for nothing. But number two looks incredible.
Number two is your payoff. And if number two does well, the guy behind it wants to do a third movie, which would be Children of the Dune.
I think they've already decided to do it.
So
we are up to $8,978.
Jeez. Are you adding all these people to your wheel?
I am.
I found it. I'm ready.
What is the matter with these people?
Suzanne, we don't care if the snow is a sheet of ice and it doesn't break.
Oh my God, Tracy, I just told her that. I said, you know what the problem is? Nobody cares. Me, I'll go do it. I'm stupid. I'm crazy. That's fine. It's all for a great cause.
Nobody
cares. One dear to my heart, between strokes and my father and heart attacks and all of that. You know, this means a lot. I will go do it. But Tracy, it's frozen. I'm going to jump onto this stuff and I'm just going to land.
So here's
I might actually break something when I land on.
And I think this is Carlos's goal. If he slips on the ice and he breaks something, he can get the wheelchair, and then he can just drive around Disney all the time on his.
Well, I can just run wheelchair. One
What are you blurring the back for?
Hi, Jerf.
I don't know. How do I change that?
He's in a witness protection program, Steve.
What's the other way?
Undisclosed location.
Well, somebody said I was like that before, too.
No, his background is completely blurred out.
No, I see it.
Oh, yeah. There it is.
Oh, there it is.
Angela must have done that. Wait, well, I better. Angela. I probably should have checked before he did that.
Jeff, here's the big donor. Jeff is here. He's ready to take over.
I'm what?
Jeff will get us there. So we've had
this recap. I want to do it.
Oh, you want to hear a recap? There's a challenge out right now, Jeff.
There is a challenge, Jeff. So right now, we're standing at $8,978 raised.
Come on, 1,022, baby. Let's go. We can do
it. If we get to 10,000
by the end of the stream,
Tina will say something in her smoky phone operator voice, and Carlos is going to go out in a Speedo and do snow angels face down.
Why not face up?
Because I thought it would be your face down.
Don't know.
Oh, shrink it. It ain't going to shrink. It's going to break because everything's frozen out there. So as soon as I land, I'm screwed. Yeah. It's just going to break.
Suzanne says she's going to break the internet.
Well, you can break out. The challenge is already out there. Somebody will call me. Be like, Carlos, what happened?
10 grand, I said witness. Oh, witness. Witness.
Oh, my gosh.
The Speedo has been found. It might be on this.
Murph says, I'm looking on my phone for anyone around Carlos who may be working tonight on the ambulance. Need to give them a warning that they may roll up on. He's a psychological trauma on them.
Suzanne says she won't go film it, but I'll take the tripod outside. We'll do everything.
We're up to $8,989.
Suzanne, maybe I should put the new ring we just bought up first. We'll catch it and just put it out there.
Suzanne, we like you.
Thank you, Julie.
We're getting there. We're getting there.
Carlos in pain more.
We're getting there. Come on.
I'm just here to check on my chocolate.
I thought they'd be, since it's going to rain all day tomorrow, that'd be a good day to deliver chocolates.
Oh, would that be a good day?
Yeah, because you're probably not going to go out in it, are you?
I'm going out in it. I'll be home by the time you wake up. You don't worry about it.
What time are you going out tomorrow? Or where are you going tomorrow?
Animal Kingdom.
Ooh, that's just like right by, that's close to my house.
No, Steve. Animal Kingdom's close to my house.
Animal Kingdom's really, this is the closest one to my house.
I know.
So Steve, I might be able to just bring them there because it's going to be cold and they won't melt tomorrow.
They will not melt tomorrow, no.
Stephen, is one of them a Cadbury?
Two of them are Cadbury.
The long one?
English Cadbury, not American Cadbury.
Yeah, yeah. Can you save one and put it with Figment?
He already knows what's in there.
He doesn't know how many came. Oh, something was wrong.
Who's that?
Not me.
No, no, it's me. Six cruisers went by before now. Fire trucks.
See, they're already prepared.
They're getting to their staging area.
Somebody's watching the stream and somebody already sent them over.
We're at $9,016.
Yeah. 916. $984 away.
Great. I have a question for everybody.
All righty.
So we went to this Mexican restaurant tonight. It delicious. They were handing out shots of tequila all night. Like for free. Wow. There was a lady dressed like she was at carnival getting out shots of tequila all night. Like, have you ever heard of that before?
Quick question. Did she give you beads?
No.
Okay.
She gave us tequila. Did you hear what I said?
Wait. Tequila. Wait. Isn't like the stipulation of getting beads is you have to flash someone, or is it the other way around?
No, that's exactly what I meant. Right? Yeah.
Oh, that's okay. Exactly. Honest question, because I didn't know. I get it confused. So that's all.
Suzanne bought beads today at Target. I'm gonna throw them
at her. Jeanette says, "Where is the question?
Where is the question?"
Jennifer Crusoe wants to know, how many did you have, Jeff?
I only had
Where 12. Are you going? Suzanne's leaving me.
Pot Roast is here. Welcome in, Pot Roast.
Where's Pepper? All we need is Pepper. We have a meal.
I can't believe I did not know you could get fries and mac and cheese with your pot roast. That made me so happy the other night that I don't have to eat those green beans.
Doesn't go together.
Yeah, Zach has a way of getting mac and cheese, no matter at Sanaa, at 50s Prime Time, anywhere he goes.
Where did you eat?
Olivia's. 50s Prime Time.
I'm going to order green French fries and call them green beans.
Green beans are awesome.
Ugh.
Except green when they're cold.
The worst green vegetable ever.
Green beans are amazing.
No. Green beans are good. It depends on which way you make them.
Green beans are great.
I will say that somebody does have better green beans than 50s Prime Time, and that's Boma.
Really?
They put some extra spices in theirs, but the ones at Primetime are great.
They make them on the grill at Boma though,
with golden raisins and something else. I can't remember what the other thing is.
We are up to $9,000 and $9,068.
Ooh. Let me do my stretches. I need to stretch. To my snowman, snow angel.
Are you stretching to get into the Speedo, or what are you doing?
No, I got to stretch the Speedo for me to get in it.
You don't want to pull a hammy getting into your Speedo.
Might be a Speedo. What is? I don't know what it is.
Theo Sam Eagle, welcome in.
We'll find something.
Now, if you do it in a jock strap.
Oh. Yeah. No, it got thrown out.
You might have to go.
I think we threw it out. I think it's thrown out. My wife.
Tracy.
Is that still in there?
No.
No, you threw it out? Yeah, I think I told you to throw it out.
She says, don't help Tracy.
Somebody may have been using that as a mask during the pandemic.
I had mine in there. I just threw it out. She's like, you don't need us anymore. No, I don't. I guess not. My playing days are done.
Oh my gosh.
So many things going through.
I don't know that I want to see anything that needs to be stretched.
No, it's for my snow angel. I'm getting the arms ready. I'm kicking the legs. The legs are being kicked.
Debbie, I am not a troublemaker. I am just here to facilitate.
Facilitate.
Same thing.
Helping this along.
They're mostly covered. We'll be fine. Or at least kind of covered.
Oh, they'll be covered, all right. Don't worry about that.
You couldn't have been gone to bed early tonight?
What?
You couldn't go to bed early tonight?
I couldn't go to bed.
You couldn't go play bingo, Suzanne?
Yeah, right?
Mike Wazowski, welcome in. We are up to $9,000, $9,079.
Oh boy!
Yeah, you do a snow angel and a jockstrap, you're gonna get like a snow butt plug if you go like.
No. But remember, he's doing it face down, so that jockstrap doesn't cover certain areas in the behind.
Well, I know what a jockstrap is.
What was the limit? What was the?
$10,000.
$10,000 was the
next goal.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
This will be far from an angel. A snow squirrel, maybe.
How much snow did you get over there, bud?
About 5 inches? 6 inches?
You okay? Is he okay?
who all got snow?
I got.
Did you get any snow, Chris?
No.
No, Tina. How much did you get?
I don't know. It's probably about 4 to 5 inches out there, but we got lake effect snow last night. So,
in one day, you got all that?
Oh my!
It was
God.
Over.
No, Thursday night into Friday, they canceled school, today's Saturday. Today we got more. We got lake effect snow. So, but the sun is so strong, it's melting. Like it's not sticking around.
How much did you get, Joy?
Oh, man. I didn't get anything.
No.
Jade lives above me, so she got some, but I didn't get any.
How much did you get, Tracy?
I got a dusting. I got missed by the big storm that came through New York. And this whole lake effect snow, I live too far south to catch any of that. So I got just a little bit of a snow on my driveway, and that's about it. And it's melting right off.
It has been warm
here. Fine for me, because you know what? I hate shoveling, and the snow blower, you know, it could stay in the garage for a couple more snowstorms. I'm still mad at it.
That's like saying I stuck my fingers under the lawnmower. I'm mad at my lawnmower.
Well, we had to plow this time. It was plowable, that's for sure.
Well, you got a couple. What do you get, like 12 inches over there?
No, we were supposed to. We ended up about 7.
It's 35 here with a feels like of 28. It's been cold here today, but up until today, Thursday, I was out in shorts and a t-shirt. It's been warm here.
Are those all your cereal puzzles back there, Steve? I see Frosted Flakes.
I got one that's put away already, the one I did the other night, but those are the other 5.
Corn Pops.
And the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtle puzzle is there. I mean, I can hold them up. They're glued. You got Frosted Flakes.
Those are already glued.
Yeah, and a Happy Smack, Honey Smack. Nice. You got the Rice Krispies. Uh-oh, that one's see-through. You got Fruit Loops and the Pops.
Nice.
Now I want cereal.
The Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles one is back here.
Oh, that's cool.
Is that like the comic book edition?
Yeah, it's got like a barcode. And still only $1.75.
Yep, Happy Smacks.
That's my biggest mistake. When Jeff goes live in the morning, I go grab a bowl of cereal, then I say hello in the chat.
That's a mistake.
It's like everybody, then you want to say hi to everybody. It's like, damn, now my cereal's soft. I hate when the cereal gets soft. I gotta eat it quick.
I do too.
What cereal are you eating?
Frosted Flakes.
Oh, yeah.
That's good.
Soggy quick.
Yeah, it's like
I don't
never say hi until I'm done with my cereal.
I don't like my Fruit Loops to get soggy either.
Yeah.
You gotta eat Fruit Loops quick.
I don't put milk in my cereal at all because I don't like it getting soggy. I'll just drink some milk with my cereal.
Okay, Ethan.
I like is it Cinnamon Toast Crunch? I like that one without milk.
That's but good.
I like other cereal with milk.
Fruity Pebbles is my favorite.
Without milk?
Well, no, Fruity Pebbles is my favorite. Well, I drink them all. I eat them all without milk.
You eat them
Fruity
all
Pebbles without is my favorite.
But then you don't have any, like...
How do you get the sugary drink? Milk?
I don't need sugary. Yeah, how do you get
the
milk
at the end?
Oh.
You get the chocolate or the Fruity Pebble milk at the end.
Please, I don't, Jeffrey, flavored teach milk. Michaela that, please, because we've tried. The she will dump milk. All the milk out at the end.
No.
Yes, her and you, Ethan.
Yeah. You pay good money for that at Everglazed.
Well, you pay for good money for milk no matter where you are these days. But she'll fill the bowl up with milk and the cereal, eat the cereal, then dump all the milk.
Oh, my God.
No way.
I would put a little milk in my cereal. And I would eat my cereal, and then whatever milk was left, I'd put more cereal in until all the milk was gone.
That's what I do, Chris. Yeah,
I'll eat just whatever I put in a bowl, but then I'll drink all the milk, and that's the best part. Yeah. Especially if you eat the cereal quick enough, where the milk is still nice and ice cold.
Stephen K had a question, and I've never heard of this or thought of it. Have you ever tried half and half in your Frosted Flakes?
I've never.
No.
Why just put heavy cream?
No. I mean, I got plenty of half and half in ours because that's what we put in the coffee, but...
I don't even drink full milk. I drink skim milk.
Ugh. Then why drink... Then it's not milk.
You might as well drink water.
Right? It's not milk. Even 1%. I mean, we buy 2% for Ethan because the doctor told us to, you know. But I won't go lower than that. What even 1% is like water.
Once you get used to it, it's tastes like milk.
I will say, like Fruit Loops or Apple Jacks, those are good for road trips because you can just grab a handful and munch on them down the road. I do like that.
Cereal today doesn't taste the same as the cereal in the 80s when you're in front of that cartoons on Saturday morning. That was cereal back then.
I don't know about you, man, but I'm 46 years old and I still have my bowl of cereal.
it has a
difference. And I'm watching a cartoon usually. It depends what time of the stream.
Yeah.
I'm also on that health, not health. Well.
Well, yeah, you can't have like sugary smacks.
Oh, I am. Well, tell me about it. I checked my blood when I got home from dinner and it was awful, but I also have like healthy cereal, like Fiber One, honey,
Murph crap, says,
or whatever it is.
Not half and half, but condensed milk, just adding more sugar. Yum. Mm.
Oh my God. That would be awful.
Now, am I the only person though, if back when I was a kid, we had to have, we would get Rice Krispies. I would have to add extra sugar to Rice Krispies.
Yes.
I had to do that with Cheerios.
Yes.
Okay. If you had Cheerios, you poured your Cheerios, poured the milk in there, and then you took a teaspoon of sugar and right over it.
Yes.
Okay. I only added sugar to Raisin Bran.
Raisin Bran?
Raisin Bran.
It's the only one I ever added sugar to.
I think we're all concerned that you were actually eating Raisin Bran than adding the sugar.
I love Raisin Bran.
If I eat cereal now, it's Raisin Bran Crunch. I like Raisin Bran Crunch.
I've been buying, well, for a few years now, the Reese's peanut butter ones. The Oreo ones.
Peanut butter puffs?
Oh. Yep. Or the Oreo ones. They have Oreo ones. Oh my God, so good.
I made a Chex Mix with the Reese's peanut butter puffs. In the Chex Mix instead of the cake. Nut.
Drinking that milk after eating a Reese's cereal, drinking that milk after, that's gold.
I tried grape nuts one time. That's like chewing gravel. That was a hard gravel.
Yep. Break a tooth doing that.
See, I like that too. It's like granola.
Yeah. Does anybody remember a cereal called Kaboom? K-A-B-O-O-M.
I do.
It had a clown. It had a clown on it. But
yeah.
Had a clown?
Yeah. My grandmother used to buy that for us. It was so good. My parents wouldn't get it for us, but my grandmother would.
Now, those of us who have siblings, me, when you got a new box of cereal, did you reach down and grab the toy inside before your kid, before your brothers or sister could?
Yeah, you pour it out. You pour all the cereal out, get the toy, then you pour it back in.
So, the Wednesday night, Kelly Mickey Bunch was on with us, and she told a funny story. She said when she and her brother were little kids, they got a special treat one day. They got their own boxes of Cap'n Crunch with berries.
Ooh, crunch.
And berries. They were so excited. She said she got up early the next morning because she was so excited to get her own box. And she poured her box of cereal, and there was no berries in her cereal. Oh. And she was bummed about it. And she said she didn't learn until like a few years back that her brother had gone through that night and picked all the berries out of her cereal and put them in his.
I accidentally bought a box of Frosted Flakes with marshmallows in it. Man, was I ticked off. I'm trying to go through it to leave the marshmallows inside.
Marshmallows and cereal, like Lucky Charms, those marshmallows are totally different than other marshmallows.
I still can't. I can't. I just want my flakes. Just give me my flakes.
Because those marshmallows.
I accidentally bought the dumb box. I saw it on sale for $1.99. I'm like, oh, grabbed it real quick. I didn't even read the box. I'm like, oh.
Always after me, Lucky Charms.
Emily says she had four siblings. I had to fight for to get the prize first. Yep.
I had three siblings.
Well, they used to put great toys in cereal.
They used to, yes.
Right. We used to get Matchbox cars back then.
Yeah, Matchbox cars, mm-hmm. They would be like baseball cards, football cards.
Yeah.
Sometimes like a little whistle or something like that.
Yeah.
Something to annoy your parents with.
Things you could use in life.
I remember Blueberry and Count Chocula.
Oh yeah!
Oh, Blueberry Count Chocula,
and there's the third one.
Frankenberry.
Frankenberry, baby.
Frankenberry.
It was yummy. Now,
Frankenberry. The milk after Frankenberry was the best.
It was yummy, mummy, fruit brute, Frankenberry, Count Chocula, and Blueberry. And then they had a new one this year. It was apple something. It was gross.
I might just go get a bowl of Frosted Flakes. It's better than these pretzels I'm eating.
Sometimes you would get a Russian bride in the box. I never got that, Justin.
Comrade Joy.
What's your go-to on a road trip then? What do you snack on when you're on a road trip?
Red vine.
Cheez-Its.
What is it?
Cheez-Its.
Cheez-Its?
Yeah.
Red vines for me.
Licorice.
Yeah, but red vines, not Twizzlers.
Red licorice, not black. Nobody likes black licorice.
I like black licorice, just not Twizzlers.
I see.
Joy?
Chex Mix that my mom makes.
I'm just chips.
Chips?
Yeah, potato? Just chips. Yeah, just chips. Yeah.
Beef jerky?
I like good beef jerky.
Yeah, 20-hour like drive, and believe it or not, I actually don't munch on things. Just when we stop for food, grab food, and that's it. I don't munch much. I chew a lot of gum while we're driving.
I like some of the granola mix that Walmart sells with the M&Ms or the peanut butter cups or something like the mini stuff. I'll get those. Those are good to snack on.
I want to try those. Zapp's Voodoo Chips from New Orleans. Those look good. I want to try those sometime. I like potato chips.
Well, I buy go to BJ's up here or Costco or whatever, wherever you have around you. And we buy like the box of like 40 or 60 bags, the mini bags. because, you know, for the kids and everything, so they can eat while down there and whatnot. So that's sort of the reason.
Okay.
Because we don't pack much of that either.
Pete, I've never done that.
Did anyone bring Nestle Quick Powder to school to add to your half pint of milk? No. You did, Steve.
You didn't have chocolate milk in your school?
No. He's doing it right now.
Yeah, but you know what? Back when we were growing up, Quick didn't come in a pouch. Quick came in a can, and sorry, you had to pop it off with the butter knife.
Right, but, I mean, crap. I know, I get it that three of you are older than me, but we had chocolate milk in school. That's what I'm saying. I didn't, you know.
I didn't.
No?
No.
No, we did.
I got in grade school. Grade school was always white milk.
I even had chocolate milk. I think I'm the oldest one here.
We had chocolate milk.
We didn't.
I remember a quick story. I remember being, it's crazy the things you remember in life. Kindergarten, we had our snacks. Everybody had their snacks. And in our elementary school, everybody would get, you know, one of those little boxes of milk. I opened mine up, started drinking it. Teacher yelled at me that I had to drink it. I says, I want it. She forced me to drink. The reason I didn't want it, because the thing was sour, and I told her it was sour. I finished drinking it. Everybody was done. She's telling everybody to put it away. I threw up everywhere. Went to the nurse's office, sent me home. Oh, your son's sick, this and that. And I explained to my mother what happened. All I know is all hell broke loose the next day. It was my mother, my father, and my aunt who came to school to rip this teacher a new one for not believing me that the milk was sour. She said... The teacher said she thought I was just in a hurry to get to the carpet. It was reading time the next
day. Wow.
Like, oh. I'm telling you, that scared me for a while about drinking milk in school. Sour milk. And she made me drink the whole quart or whatever. Not quart. In her little boxes.
Ugh. We're going to start sprinkling in some wheel spinning. Throughout the stream.
Giveaways. Let's do giveaways.
Yep. From what?
Giveaways.
Giveaways. Huh? The first giveaway, this is the wheel and all the names of all the donations.
Holy cow, how many names are on that thing?
171.
Wow.
So, Chris, just I think I
understand. You didn't put the anonymous ones in either, right?
I did not, because I don't know who anonymous is.
So. Well, that's good. There's multiple names in here?
Yes. So if you gave multiple times,
it goes by
name is on there multiple times.
That's all I was wondering. Thank you.
Yep. So I think what the first thing we're going to do is we've had a couple of donations sent in. One of them is by DizRN. He offered a pound or some of her homemade caramels that I hear are amazing.
They are good.
So that's the first thing we're going to do. So
I was hoping you were going to say hernia testing.
Holy no. Days.
prostate exam.
What is going on?
Not again.
Yeah. Chris, are you pulling the name out after each win, or are you leaving it in?
So I will take it out. If
okay.
Whoever wins, yeah. Pound of homemade caramels. Yep. So we're going to shuffle, and then we'll spin. And if anybody else donates, we'll add it in, and they can be in the next drawings. So
in other words, if you win and you want your name back in, you got to re-donate so we get closer to that 10 grand. Sure.
That too.
Does that make sense to everybody? Sound fair?
Let's roll. Okay.
So we're going to shuffle it. Steve, give me a number 1 to 10.
4.
All right. And Tina, give me a number 1 to 10.
9.
Okay. Here we go.
What's the prize for? Oh, never mind, the caramels.
This is for Desarian's pound of homemade caramels.
Pino Pete.
Man, it's his weekend. Jeez.
Wow.
Pete now has some caramel to eat with his wine.
There you go,
Pete.
Chris, do you want me to write the stuff down?
You can. I have somebody else that's writing it down for me as well.
Oh, that's fine.
You've been replaced.
I'll drop your email.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm. Tina's not keeping score.
Congrats, Pino Pete. There he is. He says, I am lucky this week. Thank you. And we've got another update. We're up to $9,084.
Awesome.
So let me add the other name in here.
I think I'm going to have to get some more coffee. I'll be right back.
All right.
Let me thank everyone that's still donating. I did put the challenge out there, and I will do it. If it happens, it happens. As much as I'm getting a little nervous, if it happens, it happens. But seriously, I mean, where the money's going, that's what matters, you know? Yeah. I think Suzanne from the other room, maybe she'll bang on the wall, will agree that, you know, the money's going to a great cause. So so keep donating. If we thank get you. To 10 grand, I will be in dummy, you know, later tonight, and Suzanne might not talk to me tomorrow, but we'll have a nice $10,000 donation to American Heart Association.
You know what? Let's go ahead and spin again.
Spin it.
Let's see. We're gonna go here.
What's the prize for?
Cy offered to send someone a box of UK chocolates and candy.
What? Come on, Suzanne. Come on, baby. I want my Cadbury because Steve won't steal one from Jeff.
Yep.
And Barry forgot to bring me one last time he was out there.
I have caramel and milk chocolate, by the way.
No, it's the milk chocolate. Oh, my God.
When Barry Daddy didn't forget. He just gave it to me, Carlos.
Yeah, I believe that, too. To be honest.
Okay.
So here we go. Let's shuffle it up, and we're going to spin it. And for UK candy and chocolate, Jeanette, Sebastian the Crab.
Yay.
It's two N's and one Y, but it's not where you think. yes, thank you, Tina. So if you win, please email me or send me a message on Instagram. With your address, and I will get it to the parties that have the prizes, or if it's a prize that I have to give out. We have several things to give out tonight, actually. So maybe we should spin it again.
Go for it.
Plus, I enjoy giving things away.
Steve, have you had any of that chocolate? I know you're holding it for Jeff, but
I ate everything that I had in like a day.
So, but I'm saying you got some. Okay, so
yeah,
you got the Cadbury milk chocolate.
Oh, it was, yeah, it's so much better than ours.
Oh God, yes, so much better. I tried to make that foot long bar last a long time.
Yeah,
it didn't.
The jammy Dodgers were gone in 10 minutes.
I don't know what those are. Barry just brought me Barry knew I loved Cadbury, the milk chocolate. And he brought me a Jeff Sword. He bought me a bar. Like, it's a foot long.
All right. We'll give Tina a minute here.
Since we have a break, who's ready for some concert series from Garden Rocks? That starts what? A week?
Starts soon, yeah.
Yeah.
In a week. I got my dining package for Crowder. That's the one I wanted the most. So
yeah, you wanted 3 or 4.
Yeah.
Yeah, but Crowder's the one I wanted the most.
Yeah. But I'll say you got the rest of them too?
Not yet. Some of them aren't available yet.
Yeah.
It's a pretty good lineup this year. Any that you're especially looking forward to, Jeff?
I'm looking forward to going see Casey and the Sunshine Band tomorrow at Universal.
I was asking really? You in the chat. You didn't see him at Epcot last year?
Okay.
Casey and Sunshine, they weren't at Epcot.
God, I could swear, because I was arguing with Suzanne, I could swear they were at Food and Wine last year. Or no. He was at Food and Wine.
I don't know if I want to get sweater tomorrow, though.
Jennifer Grusa says they're doing the dining package for Berlin, March the 8th.
Nice.
Chris, can I say something real quick?
Yes.
Just so everyone knows, I keep going off camera because I'm sick and I keep having coughing fits. I'm okay. I just have a cold.
Yeah.
Nothing. Just a cold.
We got
you. What to say? Starve a feeder, feed a cold.
Yep.
Oh, Jason says... feed adjacent and stop a cold. That's what.
That works too.
I'm sure Jeff's looking forward to Flock of Seagulls.
I am not going to Flock of Seagulls this year.
Jeff, why
not?
Please, please, that was please.
The worst concert of the year.
But you make the concert, your comments, your attitude. You have to do it for us. You have
How do they not sing Iran? How do they not sing that?
They didn't sing that?
You sure you didn't
miss it? Maybe they will this year and you'll miss it.
You sure you didn't just miss it?
No, I was here for the entire set.
It was in a different set, Jeffrey.
I know. It was
in a different set.
But they should sing that every set.
Like Jason does with 25-6-4?
Yes.
He does it every year.
It's their top song. They should sing it every set.
They totally sang it for the first 2 sets. They sang it the 3rd set.
They should sing it once and change up the music throughout the whole night.
I think all of them should do that. I agree with you there. I think every band that's there should do a different song set for every set.
Well, that works if you're going to sit through all 3 sets.
Well, that's how you get people to sit through all these sets too.
Yeah. If you want to listen to it, you got to go.
Welcome in. It's me, David T, and Wendy B came in. Hello, Wendy.
Well, we catch Flock of Seagulls the week we're there. Then M80s, Plain White Tees, and I forgot. Yeah, Suzanne and Michaela looking forward to Plain White Tees. I'm not. I'll take off with Ethan.
Who we got? What we got, Chris? What we give away?
Since Tina's not feeling well, I want to do this while she's here, just in case you have to leave early for us. Tina offered to give away a print. Tina, would you like to elaborate?
So, I should have had my link ready. I'm going to donate an 8x10 Disney print. I don't sell my prints. I don't sell my Disney photos because it's against copyright. But I will give them away as giveaways, gifts. Or reimbursement if you ever want one, and I won't upcharge you. You just reimburse me. But I'm going to give away. That's just explaining. I will give away. I'm just stalling to get the link. An 8x10 canvas. So not just like a photo print, but an 8x10 canvas of whoever wins this, winner's choice. Of all these photos.
Sweet.
And I'm posting the link right now. And these are all my photos. I took all of these photos in Disney.
I have 3. So. I got 2 of the floating mountains and 1 of the Parker statue in front of the castle.
So here we go.
Oh, go ahead.
Oh, sorry. Go ahead, Tina.
No.
All right. We got it shuffled. Here we go.
Spin that wheel.
Thank you, Nicole.
Oh! Nicole Hamilton.
Yay!
There she is.
There you go.
I mean, Russ, if Happy Haunts wants a picture of Jason in a tub, yeah, I guess she'll have to send it.
I don't have any of those. I could take one if you'd like. No flies off my back.
I think somebody's excited.
Yeah, so message me, right, Chris? Message me.
Yeah, you can message Tina on that one.
And tell me which. So all you have to do is go and click the heart on whichever photo you want, and then I'll see it. It'll show me. And just message me, screenshot it, and message me. It doesn't matter.
I want to go in and click the heart on all of them.
Well, that'll be really confusing.
I know.
Flies off my back. I don't know. It just seemed like the right thing to say, Justin.
Sweet.
So.
Congratulations, Nicole. She said, I'll take a Disney one, T.
That's what you're going to get, so.
They're all
Disney. She's so cute.
So, in other words, she doesn't want the one with Jason in the tub.
Exactly.
Yes.
Yep.
Unless it's a Disney tub, I guess.
I don't even think I have any of those. Caribbean.
Yes, she clarified. I meant not Jason, but a Disney one.
I gotcha.
That would be funny if someone requested though an 8x10 print of Jason.
I could just see.
I mean,
I'll request an 8x10 Jason.
Hey, could you?
I'm not objecting to it. I'll take one.
Could you see Jason doing the George Costanza pose?
What's that?
No,
I gotta look it up.
I'll look it up.
No, don't look it up.
Why?
You'll be sorry.
Right, because I haven't looked things up before that I was not sorry for.
Did you look up Fluffer earlier, Tina?
I'll look up Fluffer.
No, Nicole did. Was it Nicole that did it?
Yeah.
George, how do you spell his name?
Jerry? George Costanza?
George Costanza.
How do you spell his last name? Is it K or C?
Can't stands ya.
Oh.
Just reminded me to stream this one. Spell
C-O-S.
spell Worcester, Tina.
Oh, I see it. Worcester. W-O-O-S-T-A-H.
Worcester.
Okay, that's the dumbest thing I've ever heard, Carlos.
Man, I was trying to...
Yeah, listen.
I was trying to get to some more names.
We have to do a stream trying to get Jeff to say all of these names in Massachusetts.
I've been to Worcester.
It's not Worcester.
It's Worcester.
I know what they say, but it's not phonetically correct. Well, just because they're from there doesn't mean it's correct.
3/4 of our cities have been hard to pronounce.
I'm just, I cannot mispronounce something if it's spelled in front of me.
I always wondered why Ron and Meredith talk so funny, and now I know. You don't pronounce half the letters that are there, and you add letters when there aren't there.
Carlos, could you imagine him looking at the spelling of Situate and trying to pronounce it?
Lemonster.
Peabody.
Peabody. Oh, I put that one in the chat.
It says Peabody and Peabody.
Pronounce Peabody.
Man.
Like Worcester sauce on my... Yeah.
Haverhill. Like called Haverhill.
Even Hingham.
Is Woody B still in the chat?
Yes.
I had to explain to Nicole and Jennifer Caruso what Beats Bears Battlestar Galactica meant.
Oh, wow.
He did. I was there.
I was so disappointed in both of them.
That's Beats. Sad.
Beat Battlestar Beats Galactica.
Bears Battlestar Galactica.
Welcome in, Jill. The Office. Yep.
The Office.
Steve would have such a problem. Nothing in mass sounds like it's spelled.
Nothing.
Nothing.
Nope.
Murph
was says, that from Steve, one of our fellow mass people?
That was from DizRN.
I think are they from, she originally are they from up here? I think so.
Originally. Yeah.
From where? Put the city in, please. I'd like to know.
What did Murph say? See, you hit a new high. Oh, you took it away. Let's read now.
Let me open the chat.
This is true. We're going to do another giveaway.
Yay!
This is a set of jewelry that Kenneth H. got and donated. So it's a Minnie Mouse necklace and then a sets of earrings. All in rose gold. Oh, let's go here and spin again.
Ah, she's from Seabrook, New Hampshire.
Joanna Hi. King.
Born in Newburyport.
Woo!
Joanna, if you're here, please reach out and send me your
reach out and touch
address.
Something. Reach out and touch something.
All right, Chris, it's about 11 o'clock. I'm going to bail.
All right, Tracy.
Thanks for having me on again this week.
Tracy.
Nice seeing everybody. And please, Suzanne, if he gets in the snow, I want a text.
Oh, you'll get a video. Don't worry about it.
I want a video. All right. Guys, have a great night.
Bye, Trace.
Night. Have a good one.
I'm going to have to bail too, Chris. I'm sorry.
It's all right, bud.
I've been going.
You got an early one tomorrow again.
I know. Weekends fly.
Yep.
What time do you think you're going to leave the Animal Kingdom?
11-ish maybe.
Oh, I'll be out by then.
I don't think you will. Are we doing the baby food tomorrow?
Well, not if you're going Universal.
No, I probably won't.
Oh.
Well, the concert's not till at night anyway.
No. We can do baby food tomorrow.
All right. Sounds like a plan.
Well,
Jeff told her he needs his rest.
Jeff's been up since 6.
Oh, man. You want to do baby food tomorrow?
We can do baby food tomorrow.
Okay. I'll let Mike know.
All right. Let Mike know.
And Rye Guy, Casey yeah. wants to come. So,
sweet. Sounds good. Good eating.
See you tomorrow, brother.
All right. Thanks, Chris.
Have a good night, Jeff. Good to see you, sir.
Have a great. Sorry. The Mexican's coming back to haunt me. Have a good night.
DizRN answered the question earlier. She said she's originally from Seabrook, New Hampshire, born in Newburyport.
Yeah, I saw it. Yeah. Nice. I come back. Everybody's gone.
Yep. We're going to do another giveaway. This is for a Minnie Mouse Forever Minnie bracelet and Bubble Bar Minnie Mouse earrings. If I mispronounce Bubble Bar, I'm sorry, but that's what it looks like to me. So, got so that's it shuffled. What it means. Here we go.
And it is...
Windy B!
Windy
B! Congratulations, Windy. I think I need Windy's address. I need your address, Windy. You won. You won this Bubble Bar Minnie Mouse earrings. and a Forever Meaning bracelet. There you go. Congratulations. Oh, not that button. And I've got one more thing from Kenneth H. We could do another giveaway here. This is the Figment stained glass effect jumbo pen. So let's remove.
It looks so cool.
I like that pen a lot. Here we go. Kay will be. Yay, Kay.
Nice.
Here you go. Kay's name's on there several times. So, Kay, you still have more chances to win.
Nice.
Nathaniel says, Chris, you could do as many giveaways as you want. I give you permission. Thank you. I appreciate it.
Nice of him.
So, hey, I think I do need your address too. So, yeah, please email me or on Instagram, either one. They are, Russ. I appreciate everybody that's donated it. I said it Wednesday when I started the stream, because of everything that's been going on with Dad, and this week, especially the first part of this week, I just didn't feel as prepared as I wanted to be. And I was just hoping and praying that we got close to 6,000. I never would have expected 8,000, let alone the 9,000 we've got to tonight. It's amazing. And I can't say thank you enough for all the support. Everybody that hung with me all day Wednesday, whether you were on screen with me or in chat, moderators that hung with me and helped all day. Thank you. Is not enough. Yeah. Jill, we're up to $9,084.
Good job.
Oh, here's the pen. I'll show the pen again. That was the pen we gave away, Wendy.
Yeah, it's awesome.
I really like that one.
Sorry.
No, go ahead, Tina.
Okay, Willby.
The first bubble bar stuff?
Yes. Was Wendy B.
Okay.
The first one was Joanna King, and then Wendy B won the Minnie Mouse bubble bar earrings, and then...
Gotcha.
Yeah, I forgot. Wendy loves Figment. There you go. Yes, Joanna King. The first one. Thank you. So, let me go here. I got a couple of things here that were sent to me to give away. It might be sick. Yeah.
It will be if we hit 10,000.
That's true.
This is true.
Very true. Yep.
I missed something. I'm sorry. I don't know. Chat.
All right.
Justin said this show is nothing like Game of Thrones. Oh, does Chris want? Yeah, it should be fine. And then Spaceship Bear says, with people taking 90% off, it might be soon.
Never know.
Weedy B says, I'm thrilled with Bubble Bar. Figment can die a fiery death, in my opinion.
Oh, boy.
So many people I used to like that I'm starting not to anymore. Wendy just made the list.
Thank you. Yeah.
I love Figment.
Thank you, DesRN.
I might need an RN if we get to 10 grand.
So here's giveaway. Another one. This is the Mickey Toy Soldier popcorn bucket from Christmas. Donated by Casey. And this thing is so cool. It's huge. I didn't realize how big that was from the pictures. But it's really cool.
That's what Suzanne said.
So let's see who can win a Mickey popcorn bucket. Debbie Bernfeld.
Way to go, Debbie. Debbie.
Yay. Oh, she's gonna love that.
I hope you like it, Debbie.
I'm waiting for a comment from a certain someone to Matt.
Oh yeah.
Watch.
She says yippee. There you go. On its way to you, Debbie.
Yep, there it is.
What are we waiting for, T?
It's in the chat, and that's exactly what I knew.
Stephanie L, welcome in. Hello, hello. Good to see you.
She's gonna swat you, Justin. Just wait.
I don't see anything in the chat at all.
Oh, Justin, this is what she was waiting for. Let me get back to it.
Like, I knew it was coming.
Is it back farther?
No, it didn't show up in StreamYard, which is funny.
Well, that's where I'm looking at. I can't find it.
But in the other chat, Justin said it's bigger than you, Mama Debbie. Yeah, he's not wrong.
It's fun size, just like
fun Mama size. Debbie. I've got another one to do here. I love giving away stuff. We should do this every Saturday night. This is fun.
This is fun.
To be clear, I'm not painting something every week.
Oh, okay.
Don't you have enough? To give away like 152 paintings for each week of the year.
I'm gonna put two things together here. We're gonna bundle. You get one of the Mickey Walt Disney World Starbucks tumblers.
Don't bundle.
And a Seiko aerial foil puzzle, 500 pieces. So there you go. You can sip and chill and puzzle together. That's a really good puzzle. I've put that one together. Let's see who gets the Starbucks and the puzzle. Katie Wah.
Yay.
Katie Wah.
Wait a minute. Isn't she the one that sent us the puzzle?
No.
Oh.
That was Corby.
Corby that's right.
Corby donated the puzzle. Casey's Corner of the World, the Starbucks tumbler. And there's Katie. Hey, there you go.
She's excited.
Congratulations, Katie.
Atta girl.
But wait, there's more, says Nathaniel. There is more. This is probably one of my favorites. We'll give away tonight.
Ooh. I see the picture.
This is from the Disney Art Store. This is the Fantasia Mickey light up shadow box.
That is so cool. I've seen it
from the art store at Disney Springs.
Oh my gosh.
This thing, I have not taken it out of the box. I've had this since Casey sent it to me about a month ago. I've been dying to take it out of the box and look at it, but I haven't. I've left it sealed for the winter. This is a picture I got off of the web, but this thing is gorgeous. I can't wait to see who wins this one. So here we go. Sue Glover.
Ooh. Do we figure out who Sue was in the chats?
I have not. So, Monorail Molly says, OMG, I almost bought that last month.
Do I still have it? I want that.
Yeah, it's gorgeous.
Yeah. So, Sue, please message me on Instagram or send me an email with your address. I'll get it out to you. Some of the names I recognized, as Tina mentioned a minute ago, some of the names I recognized from the donors, from knowing people, there were a few I didn't. So, Sue, if you go by a different name in chat, I didn't know your other name, but, please message me. And I'll be glad to get that out to you. So, and Sparkly Pink is keeping track for me tonight. So thank you, Sparkly Pink. And Big Matt came in. Welcome in, Big Matt. Hello, hello. Good to see you. Yeah, I know you can, Zanlax. I didn't get the fish up tonight. I was too busy trying to get everything ready for the giveaways and all. So no fish behind me tonight, but you can see the spinning wheel in the reflection. So
just like Inception.
Just like Inception.
Oh, Chris.
Yes.
What movie you watch tomorrow?
I was going to ask you that.
Oppenheimer.
Is it out?
Yes.
Oh. Then tomorrow night, in celebration of Valentine's Day, we're going to be watching Oppenheimer tomorrow night.
What's it all on?
Peacock.
It is on Peacock.
Okay.
I can't. It's hard for me not to push that button today. I'm not gonna lie.
We are watching Oppenheimer. Yes, there it is. Wonderful. We will be watching that tomorrow night.
Yes.
Something to watch next Friday. Yay.
Are we starting that at 9 o'clock or 8 o'clock, Steve?
Whatever time you want. I usually start at. I'm okay with 8.
That's a 3-hour movie.
Oh, yeah, then 8.
We might need to start that one at 8 tomorrow night. So, good night, Jennifer Crusoe.
And I might have 2 bags of popcorn. Good night.
Bye, Jennifer.
Yep, there we go. Tomorrow night, 8 o'clock, Oppenheimer. So, a feel-good story. Exactly, Nick. It's the story of a man and his love of science. I guess. Let's do another giveaway.
How many awards it won? It was crazy.
Steve's got some stuff for us to give away.
I do. I guess it's your stuff. Oh, do I need to get it? Do you want me to get it?
I forgot to load a picture of it. So
it's right.
One of the things we're giving away, Steve picked up for me.
I'm giving away Carlos's popcorn bucket. That might be the one Chris had me pick up for him for this. That's but the
one I had, yeah, I had Steve pick up one for me the other day. So that we're giving away the new
Figma. It lights up, but I haven't pulled the tab yet.
There you go.
Good job.
Oh.
And it still has a popcorn in it.
Oh, but he pulled the one on mine. Oh, thanks, Steve.
I didn't pull yours unless you told me to.
I think you did it. I think you played with the light.
I don't remember.
Yeah.
Good night, Tina McNeil.
Have Do you want one. This one to together, Chris, or no? With the other thing.
Either way, yeah, you can.
What's yours? I don't care. We have another one of the aerial puzzles that he just had.
We'll put that in with the popcorn bucket.
So he originally said, let's pair them. I said, no, don't pair them. Keep them all separate. And he goes, okay. And then he threw a curveball at me with the last one. So we'll just throw that one in there too.
We're going to pair them.
Oh.
So the Figment popcorn bucket.
And aerial puzzle.
And the aerial puzzle. There it is again.
Yeah.
Wait, that's a second aerial puzzle?
I have one. So. Gotcha.
Okay.
Corby was generous enough to send us both them. We both have already put it together. So we decided this is like 6 to 8 months ago.
Yeah.
We both said, let's save it for the giveaway for the American Stroke Association.
Okay.
Oh. Here we go.
Popcorn bucket. I hope Carlos wins.
Good luck.
Corby.
Oh, no.
Well, Corby, right, wants the popcorn bucket. If you,
Corby, we'll give you the popcorn bucket. We won't give you the puzzle because you've already got the puzzle too.
So we'll put the puzzle with the other thing I got. So.
There we go.
That'll work. Respin for the puzzle. Give people more chances. Come
we
on.
Can respin okay for the puzzle.
Yeah, respin the puzzle.
Okay, this will be just for the puzzle.
Just there for the go puzzle. All right. Congratulations, Corby, on the popcorn bucket.
Wasn't it last year that something like that happened too?
I think
somebody donated something and went right back to him.
Right back to him. Yeah.
Yeah, something like that.
Yep. All right. So here's for the puzzle. The Little Mermaid puzzle. Disney 100 puzzle. Here you go. Jan S. Nice.
Yay.
Congratulations, Jan. Jan is on there a few more times, too.
Cool, very cool. Nice.
Nice. And then Steve is also going to donate a painting.
Oh, yeah. Not the one Chris wanted me to do, because I tried. I got it drawn, but I couldn't do it.
Yeah.
That's going to take some experimenting.
All right.
So basically, it'll be like one of these, which not this one, because this is for the Magic Night Hope, but it'll be a character of your choosing on one of these things.
There you go.
So.
So here we go. It's not a painting of Jason in the tub.
No. Yeah, I can paint it with Jason in the tub.
You know what? I'll get that over to you, photo, so you can copy it.
No, no, I have to do a live sculpture.
Oh, gotcha.
Kenneth!
Kenneth.
Great. Awesome. You're going to come up with some exotic person I don't know.
That is awesome.
Jason will be saying, paint me like one of your French girls, Steve.
Yes. Wearing this and only like this.
From the art festival, Greg McCullough does Hidden Mickeys. I'm going to start doing Hidden Jasons in my...
I'm going to be just a tiny bit selfish here and say I'm glad Kenneth H. won something. Kenneth donated several times to this. And yep. Kenneth was also here all day Wednesday modding for me, dropping yep. the link, dropping updates and everything. And
I wish you would have won something a little better, but hey.
Donated donated items for the giveaway. So thank you, Kenneth, for everything so much.
Sad boy.
Yeah. So, here we go.
Okay, Kenneth's awesome.
Yeah.
And I've got two last things to give away.
I know what they are. You showed them the other night when we were on live on stream.
I did. So, here is the first one. This is.
Yes.
This is new, just out. This is a Mickey Mouse classic Disney 100 from the Vault collection.
You sent it to me, Jan. I probably already have it, but go ahead and send it to me again.
And then there is your liner with the different images.
It's beautiful.
There you go. Loungefly. There we go. And the winner of that one is
suspense.
Debbie Bernfeld.
Yay. Oh, she's going to love it.
That is awesome. Congratulations, Debbie. There you go.
Kay Wilby says, what about her donations that she sent you photos of?
Kay, yes. Thank you, Kay. I knew there was something I was forgetting, Steve.
Well, I just read her comment. I didn't know.
Yes, yes. All right. I got to pull these up. We have more prizes. I think this happened last year, too, where more things were donated as we went along. It's great. I love
it. I'll add this toothbrush as an item.
What? Jason just texted me and said, are you trying to sell me? Not at all. Awesome.
We can't give you away right now. Well, you think we're going to get money for you?
All right. Okay. Let me go here. Oh, man. And pull up all the pictures you sent me. This is great. I love giving away stuff. This is so awesome.
Am I allowed to back glue or do I need to wait?
Huh?
Can I go ahead and start back gluing or do I need to wait for this to be over?
You can go ahead and start back gluing. Can I play the intro for you?
You have to do it six times or just the one for all of them?
We'll just do it one for all of them. Here we go.
You all gallivant with your fancy foosball friends at school while I'm sitting here all day with nobody to keep me company except Steve?
So here's something interesting about my glue. Like, I have different bottles for the front and the back of my puzzles.
Front and back, front and back.
Yep. All right. There are these. Let me go here. Make sure I did not. Nope, we're good. All right. Awesome. Uh-oh. So the first thing we're going to do is spill glue, apparently.
Yeah, almost.
Julie McKellen says that clip is never not funny. Nathaniel says, I feel deprived of 5 clips of glue. Here is the first one we'll do. This is the Happy Birthday Clown Brickhead set.
Oh, nice. We got Lego.
We got some Lego in here. So that'll be the first one we're doing. Let me go here and spin for the Lego. Jeanette Sebastian the Crab.
Jeanette.
Congratulations, Jeanette. And
let's see. Is that the Jeanette with 2 N's and 1 Y? Or?
That is with Jeanette with, yeah, but the Y is in a different place this time.
Okay.
Molly says, I would love to win a bottle of Steve's back glue autographed.
Hey, you know, I can make it happen, except it will be dirty.
I'd pay to glue Steve's back.
No.
Why did I come back into Steve's back glue?
Carlos said something about glue in my back.
Oh, I don't
know. After Molly said she'd pay for an autographed bottle of my back glue.
Jennifer.
The next item is a Cruella de Vil. This is a Hot Topic exclusive diamond version of Cruella Funko Pop.
Nice.
And it looks like it's coming in a plastic case, protective case as well. So that's cool. Let's remove Jeanette. And here we go. Wendy B.
Wendy. You know what? Wendy looks a lot like Glenn Close. I'm not saying she's Cruella.
Yeah.
Just saying, Wendy could pull it off. If Glenn Close could pull it off.
No, diamond I version. Think she's much prettier than Glenn Close.
100%. I just said she kind of looks like her.
It's the hair.
That's what, yes.
Okay, yeah, I could see that.
Wendy loves puppies.
You're welcome in. Congratulations, Wendy. The next one we've got is, this takes me back to my childhood. It is Hamburglar.
What?
Oh my God, he's in a new commercial for McDonald's.
I think this is cool. I would like to have a whole set of these. So here we go. Funko Pop? Huh?
Was it a Funko Pop?
It is a Funko Pop. Here you go. There you go.
Oh, that's cool.
Hamburglar Funko Pop. Our winner of the Hamburglar is Dawn from the Hitchhiking Bones.
Nice.
Congratulations, Dawn. The next one, Kay sent several of these. It's awesome. This one, I ain't gonna lie, I almost didn't include this one and just was gonna tell Kay to send it to me. This is an Amazon exclusive from the art series. It is Baloo, and he's painted like jungle print. In a protective case as well. Really cool. I haven't ever seen that one, so that's awesome. And Blue will go to. Oh, wait, Kay. We're going to have to respin.
Oh.
We got to respin because Kay donated those. So let me respin here. The boy child.
Oh, wow.
Nice.
Oh, wait a minute.
The boy child. I promise you the boy child.
No. What I'm going to say
don't
is.
Don't tell him.
That boy's going to keep that, and you're not going to get it. So.
Exactly. The boy child did donate. It stunned me Wednesday night. He popped in several times throughout the day, cause he was sitting here with dad, but, he did his own donation without telling me he was donating.
That's awesome.
Nice.
Yeah. That
maybe he'll give it to you for Christmas in 5 years.
Huh?
Maybe he'll give it to you for Christmas in 5 years.
Maybe so.
That's awesome.
Katie Y says, I love that he won. That's so cool.
He'll like it. I mean, see, donating does good things.
Yep. Here, let me message him because I think he's here.
Ooh, that'll be good.
Oh, let's see here.
He may be asleep, knowing him. But here's the next one. This one's cool. I've never seen this one. This is Mike Wazowski, but it's when he's prepping. He's got his, like, spray and his pan helmet hat on. Mm-hmm. So it's like when he's looking for Boo. So Mike Wazowski will go to... Angela Minta Snickerdoodle.
Nice.
Congratulations, Snickerdoodle. Go here. And then pull up the next picture. There she is. Congratulations, Snickerdoodle. That is a cool version. I've never seen that version of Mike Wazowski. It's cool.
It's hard for me to claim Snickerdoodle on this one. I just saw her name pulled. Dang it, I forgot.
The next one, this is another one in the art series. This is Pinocchio.
Oh.
Really cool. I like that paint job on him as well. Again, in the protective case, an Amazon exclusive. Pinocchio will go to Christine Hickman.
Nice.
Congratulations, Christine.
Pinocchio is my favorite. The favorite one so far, I mean.
I like that one. And the last one in the art series again, this is Robin Hood.
Oh.
With like forest painting on him and some bows and arrows. I love the original Robin Hood movie. So this is cute.
You want Taron Egerton?
No.
Oh.
The animated one with Baloo.
Oh, gotcha. With Baloo.
Yes, he played Little John.
Okay.
Robin Hood will go to T. Marie.
Nice. She not here.
There she is. Congratulations, T. And that is all the ones from Kay. Kay, thank you again so much for donating those. Those are so cool. I'm sorry, I forgot. But thank you. Hey, look, it's the boy child.
Boy child.
I heard through the grapevine one, so fingers crossed it's a date with Steve.
Yes.
Those are hot commodities these days. That is funny, boy child. But no, you won this, which I may steal from you. It is a Baloo Funko Pop from the art series. There you go.
There, Purple Subi. Just I wasn't going to say her name earlier. She's. Yes. I knew who she was. I was going to tell you after the stream.
Congratulations, Sue. if you could send me your address, either via email or Instagram, and I will see that you get your prize. I've given away so much stuff, I can't remember exactly what you won, but you did win something really cool. So,
it was early too, wasn't it?
I believe it was. Sparkly Pink, if you can help me and remind me what Sue won, I will show it here if it's something I have here. So
that was a lot of back glue.
Yeah. The light up shadow box. That's who won the light up shadow box.
Oh, that's right.
Sue.
You're gonna be happy.
You're gonna like this. So Sue, you won. Let me go back to the picture here.
Wendy V said, if nobody wrote it down, I'm pretty sure I won a car.
So you won from Disney Art Store at Springs. You won this Fantasia Mickey light up shadow box. Comes with her certificate and everything. So there you go, Sue. Congratulations. Send me your address, like I said, and we'll get it out to you.
Oh. It's really cool. I've seen it in person.
Very cool. I'm having people that won stuff for me send their address to you, and you exactly. Yes. So send me your addresses, and I'll get it out to, because Steve, a couple other people have the prizes. So yeah, send it out to me. She says, hi, everyone. I knew Steve would know me. There you go. Well, congratulations, Sue. Thank you for donating, and congratulations.
I keep a spreadsheet database of everybody just so I know who they are. So.
Sweet. And now I think this is officially the last item that I have to give away. Yes. And it is another, lounge fly. This is the Mickey Mouse Clubhouse lounge fly. There's your side image. The back has Mickey Mouse with his drum. And then there is your liner with the clubhouse characters and hat and everything. So there you go. This one will go to Goodnight Main Street, Nick. Spaceship Ears.
Yay, John.
Congratulations, John. I like the black and white on that too. I do, Nathaniel. It's a cool one.
I like that picture of him in the back. I might get a tattoo of that.
Yeah.
Him with the drum?
With the drum?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Was it the next photo? Was it
there that one? That's cute.
That'd be a nice tattoo. I love that.
Yeah. Chris?
Yes.
Can I won the Robin Hood Funko, right?
Yes.
Can I donate that to someone?
Yes.
Okay, I want to donate it to Kate Udalali.
Awesome. Okay. Sure.
I'll remind you. I'll send you a text.
Send me a text. Yep. That we can do that. I'll have to reach out. Jeanette's here.
Oh, she's always quick wit.
Congratulations on winning tonight, Jeanette. So, cool. Kate would love that. That's awesome.
She was the first person I thought of.
So, Spaceship Ears. Yep. I'll get with John, get his address. And there we go.
Great job, guys. Good job, Chris.
Whatever John won, Cool. She also wants to donate, but to me. Says Justin. Oh, whatever Joy won. She also wants to donate. Cool. Sorry.
I thought I was hearing things.
Christ. Did you have... Okay, and this is just my memory. Joy told me that she was going to donate something. A painting.
Joy, are you donating a painting too?
One that I painted.
Yes. Awesome.
If you want to give that one
again.
I just remember she was so excited when she
joined. I got a salt shaker. I just kind of want to see that when that thing spin.
A salt shaker. If you sign it, I'm sure people would not mind getting it. Salty Steve.
Joy's painting goes to.
Oh my god!
You asked for it, Tina.
Oh, that is funny. That I will take because I wanted that.
There we go.
She really liked it, so that's funny.
That is funny. There you go. Congratulations, Tina. Tina, if you would send me your address, and I'll be sure to get that to Joy. To you.
Sure.
Mandy B says it's fixed, LOL. I swear it's not. I just clicked spin and it spun.
Did the spinny spin. Thank you.
There's really no way I could fix it with that many names still on this wheel. Yeah.
Chris, listen, let me start off by saying congrats, seriously, on, not even congrats, well done. Well done.
Thank you.
Not like it was a game, so, but well done. I don't know what the total is right now. I know I'm not going in the snow.
You're not.
No. I know good. I'm not going to break any sticks on me.
We ended up at $9,084.94.
You know, hey, a couple of $100 tonight.
Yep.
You know, I don't want to think it was because of the challenge, but just the generosity of some people.
Absolutely.
Maybe they wanted to see me suffer. Good. That's good. That's why I did it. But seriously, well done, sir. And I am signing off because I think I fell asleep during a couple of spins, and I apologize for that. So I know I open my eyes, and I'm like, oh, we're still here. Good. And I think I remember laughing at something. I don't know what. But I got up really early today. Just done.
Appreciate you coming in and hanging
out. Love you all. This was fun. But more importantly, the money, I mean, seriously. I know you said it. You know, you were hoping to just get the six, not expecting to get the seven to eight, but the $9,000. What's that, like $3,000 over last year, right?
Last year, we ended up at $5,521.
All right. So we're shooting at $12,000 for next year. We're gonna keep climbing. We're going to keep climbing, buddy, because people love what you do and know what the cause means to you and your family. So we'll bust our butts more next year to get up there. So, and Suzanne won't let me, jump in the snow. So I won't be doing that next year. All right. On that note, good night, everyone. Enjoy the rest of your weekend. And I'm sure we'll see.
Have a good one, brother.
Bye, Carlos.
See you all soon.
See you.
Bye.
I'm going to go to Chris.
All right, Tina.
Can't hack it anymore. Have a good night, guys.
Thank you.
And everything Kylo said, I echo it. So
you're lucky you're sick. I'm not gonna try to keep you around.
Thank you. I have to be sick for you not to try to keep me around. Thanks.
Well, I was still gonna try, and then I thought,
thanks for cutting me some slack.
No.
All right, bye guys.
Bye. Hi, Tina. Joy, thank you for the painting. I think you mentioned that on stream one night. I didn't write it down.
Yeah, so, I'll show it to you.
I want to see it. I haven't seen it, I don't think.
Yeah.
Okay, I'll get it.
Yeah. This was fun.
We should talk about movies, Chris.
We can.
And TV shows. because I don't want to go to bed. I slept in this morning.
Oh, yeah, it's the Tinkerbell. I remember this now. I
can't see it because I put it in a frame.
Oh, nice.
I can see
it. Yeah.
Very nice.
I like that.
Yeah, I did it like 17 times, literally.
You've done that one 17 times?
Yes, and I threw it in the trash like 17 times. Oh. That was my final one.
You sure can, Nathaniel. I'll be glad. Yeah, I appreciate that very much. And we just had another donation by Jeff Condon. Got us to $9,111.
Aw, nice.
Thank you, Jeff.
Thanks, Jeff.
One more to get us over 9,100. So thank you, Jeff. That's awesome. Yeah, thank you so much for everybody that I said it earlier. I'll say it again. Because I can't say it enough, but thank you for everybody that donated for the giveaways, everybody that hung out with me on screen or in chat all day Wednesday, all the moderators that helped all day Wednesday. Nathaniel was here most of the day. Kenneth was here most of the day, and y'all didn't quit, and I appreciate it and appreciate everybody that just hung out and chat with me all day. Cause yeah. I was very nervous. I ain't gonna lie. I was nervous going into it. So, I really appreciate everybody, the support, the encouraging messages I got days before in the morning of from people meant the world to me. Yeah. This is a big day for me during the year because it does hit home for me. It's something that we deal with on a daily basis, and that's why I went with this charity as my goal for each year, my project each year, and so it means a lot to me, and I appreciate everybody that helps out and hangs with me and all the support and all the donations. Good grief, the donations. I can't believe y'all are amazing. So I can't thank you enough, but thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. So, yeah. Yep, that's true. Thank you, Nathaniel. All right, Steve, we can talk about movies now.
I want to know what Joy wants to watch.
What movies I want to watch?
What's on your radar? What TV shows? What movies?
Well,
there's a lot of good stuff coming out.
Well, there's the Barbie movie I want to watch. I know that's old, but I still want to watch that. I know you guys watched it, but I haven't watched it yet. Let's see what TV shows. Isn't there a new Marvel series coming out? TV show. Is there not? I thought there was. I don't know. We don't watch much TV.
Have you watched, have you and Justin watched the Marvels yet, Joy, now that's on Disney Plus?
No, we're going to. We haven't done it yet. Yeah. He says he doesn't really want to, but he doesn't want to not watch it. Oh, I do want to watch Deadpool, though. Deadpool 3, right?
Oh, yeah. Deadpool 3.
Yeah. You said that one's going to be good, so I'm hoping that it is, because the last couple of Marvel movies have not been that good to me.
Echo came out in January, yeah.
And what is that Marvel?
Yep.
Oh, we'll probably have to watch that too. We have to watch all the Marvel stuff.
Jeanette says, and you're going to get more. You might never see it, but company matches will come. That's cool. I didn't see that last year, but I got some emails about that as well. So,
I'm waiting for the second season of this show to come out. the, well, you can't see it, but it's the what is it called? The dragon part of the game. Castle House Dragon. Yeah.
I'm looking forward to that.
Coming out like summer of this year, right? Is that right? Or am I wrong?
That was what I heard, I thought.
Yeah.
Summer of this year.
I also want to see the Lord of the Rings one too. With season two of that.
I still haven't watched the first season of that.
It's good.
I loved it. That was fantastic. So I mean, Amazon paid the most money in the history of TV to get that, I think.
Yeah.
It was. I think they did a great job with it. I think it was well worth it.
And I can will be. Thank you again for the donations and for the giveaways. Thank you, Kay, for everything. Hope you have a good night. Sorry, Joey.
No, you're fine. We're currently rewatching all the Lord of the Rings movies in chronological order. We just watched the third Hobbit movie tonight.
Nice.
I don't think Justin's seen the first the Hobbit part of it that we watched. He's watching this for the first time, but then we're going to rewatch the original ones now, I guess.
I have not watched the Hobbit movies. I watched the Lord of the Rings movies, but not.
Why are
the
these Hobbit. Not on our radar right now, Chris?
I don't know. I read the books. I really enjoyed the books for the Hobbit series. I started to read the Lord of the Rings books, and I didn't like those books.
Oh, really?
But I love the movies. So, yeah.
Well, I think they're really good. The Lord of the Rings, the first three are better, but the Hobbit ones are good.
I agree.
I never thought I'd like any of those Lord of the Rings movies, but I went to see, I think, all of them by myself at the movie theater like multiple times.
Oh yeah.
So yeah, I got lucky because I didn't think I'd like it either, and I missed the first one and the second one. And right before the third one came out, my brother tried to get me to watch it. Well, a couple months before it, I watched the first one, thought it was the stupidest thing I'd ever seen. And then I went back and he made me sit down and we watched all of them together because he wanted to go into the watch the next day, wanted to go watch the movie. So I sat and watched them, and then I don't know, something changed.
Yeah.
Now I think they're one of the greatest things cinematic because TV has ever done. So.
I'm looking forward. I mentioned earlier the Kingdom of the Planet of the Apes or whatever it is. That looks good to me. There's another one that I'm looking forward to, and y'all may laugh, but I'm looking forward to that, to the next Godzilla King Kong movie.
Yep. No, I like all the Godzillas.
I like those movies.
I think I told you, you need to still watch Monarch. Legacy of Monsters is one of the best things that's on TV.
I do need to watch that.
Nathaniel's correct. Secret Invasion was blech.
Secret Invasion was boring.
Which I knew I was going to hate.
Yeah.
Y'all are going to be mad at me, but I liked it better than the Loki series.
Really?
No way.
Hey, she's over her limit of words tonight. Can you?
I knew you were going to be mad about that. I don't like the whole like time thing.
I don't like it either. But the second season was way better than the first season.
Well, that's true, but I still didn't like it.
But I hated Secret Invasion.
Really?
That
I hate it, but I was disappointed. I was really disappointed in it, the way it ended.
I hate the. I do love Ben Mendelsohn.
Yeah.
But I hated. I hated She-Hulk. I hate the Ms. Marvel or whatever that show was called. All these spin-off Marvel shows. This whole multiverse phase thing is just stupid, and I don't like any of the shows that go with it.
I think. I don't know. I think that's why I'm looking so much forward to, Deadpool 3, because it's going to be dramatically different than a lot of those that that we've seen lately. I mean, the trailer alone is hilarious. When he says he'll be your Marvel Jesus, that just cracked me up. So, I'm interested to see where it's going. The She-Hulk was
trash.
I tried to stick with She-Hulk, and that final episode just made me angry.
Every episode made me angry.
Yeah.
I like the girl, though, the chick that was hanging out.
I like her.
With the guy, with the Wong guy.
Yeah. I'm really looking forward to Daredevil next year.
Yes, I was going to say the exact same thing.
That I think is going to be really good. So Madam Web came out Wednesday, which is a Sony movie. It's a spinoff of the Spider-Man universe. She's a character in the Spider-Man comic books. That movie is now tanked to a 13% on Rotten Tomatoes.
It's awful.
I'll tell you why it's awful, Steve. It was written by the same two writers that wrote Morbius.
Oh, that makes it even worse. It's not, I mean, I haven't seen that. I can't be fair. I have to be fair and say I haven't seen it, but it looks terrible and it's getting terrible reviews.
I've watched a lot of reviews of it, and a lot that usually aren't slanted badly towards these top movies, and all of them say that it is a completely horrible movie.
It's not Disney, though.
Yeah.
Let's state that. That part, we got to break that one out. That one doesn't go with the rest of the ones we're talking about.
No. There's a new one coming to Netflix in March that I'm kind of excited for. It stars Millie Bobby Brown, from who you might remember from the Stranger Things series. But it is, oh God, what was the title of it, Steve?
Apple Falls Far?
No, the
which one?
One on Netflix. Damsel. It's called Damsel.
Oh, yeah.
It's sort of a twist on a fairy tale story. She plays the princess who basically gets sacrificed for the kingdom without her knowing she's about to be sacrificed. It looks really, I like the twist to it. Looks good. So that comes out in a couple of months. The one Steve was talking about earlier, is Apples Never Fall, starring Annette Bening, Sam Neill. That's coming to Peacock. And I was trying to see when a date was for it.
I thought it was like March 1st or 3rd. I don't remember.
March 14th. Yep. So not too far out. Jake Lacy. There's some faces that I kind of recognize, but the big ones are Annette Bening and Sam Neill. But that looks really good. It's
Jake Lacy's really good too.
Yeah. Twisters, I was surprised, looked pretty good. Yeah. Tron is coming out with another movie, but I don't think it's going to be related to the Tron Legacy, which kind of disappointed me.
Aw.
It's going to star Jared Leto.
Yeah. Jake Lacey was one of the kids in the last season of The Office.
Oh, yeah.
Pete, I think, is who he played.
There is a Quiet Place prequel coming out. And
yep. It looks freaky.
That looks freaky and good.
Shows how they got here.
Yeah. I want to watch that one. I'll be honest. I didn't make it through The Quiet Place, the first one, but I'd love to watch the prequel.
So. Well, you didn't like it, or you just...
Oh, no, I really liked it. It just, it got to a certain point, and
I scared you a little bit.
I just haven't been able to go back to it yet.
So you haven't seen the second one then either?
No, I haven't. It got to that point where that thing was going to happen, and I didn't want to see that thing happen that was going to happen, and I hadn't gone back to it yet.
Oh.
There was one for Fall Guy starring Ryan Gosling.
Well, I've seen previews for that last year, but it looks really good.
Let's see. Did you ever go see The Beekeeper, Steve?
Did I see what? I'm sorry.
The Beekeeper.
Not yet.
I kind of wanted to see that.
Me too. There's a lot going on right now, and I haven't been able to get to the movie, so I need to
get back. The new Ghostbusters movie.
Yep.
That one looks good. Frozen Kingdom, Frozen something.
Frozen Empire?
Yeah. That's what it is. The Bob Marley biopic is out now. That one looks pretty good.
The what?
Bob Marley biopic. It's the story of Bob Marley.
I don't think it's called biopic though. I think it's called Someone I Love.
Yeah. I was just saying it's the biopic of Bob Marley.
Oh, gotcha.
We talked earlier, Doom Part 2 comes out March the 1st.
Yep. Just like 2 weeks away.
Yep. There's another Kung Fu Panda coming out.
Yep. Number 5, I think. Four. Yeah. I can't wait for Moana 2. I love the first one.
Jake Gyllenhaal is starring in a remake of Roadhouse.
Yes, that looks good.
I haven't watched the trailer for that yet.
It looks real good.
That's coming to Prime March the 11th.
Is it really come that fast?
Yep. Ghostbusters comes out March the 22nd. Godzilla Kong comes out the 29th. Monkey Man. Have you seen the trailer for that?
What is that?
This is a... it's directed by Dev Patel. And it stars Dev Patel. It's also from... what's his name? That did like the Nope series. The Nope movie. And
Notebook,
something. No, Nope, Nope.
Oh, Nope.
Yeah.
No, I hate those. Keegan and Peele or something. Key and Peele.
Yeah. Yes, that's it. Let's see. There's the Ministry of Ungentlemanly Warfare. Comes out April the 19th. That's Henry Cavill. Alan Richson's also in that one, who plays Reacher. But that's the one where it's set in World War II and Henry Cavill forms a team of like a suicide squad that just goes nuts on Nazis and killing them. It looks hilarious.
Oh, it's a comedy thing?
It's from Guy Ritchie.
Oh.
who did like the Sherlock movies.
Yeah.
Yeah.
When he married to Madonna at one point in time.
Yeah, I believe he was. Fall Guy comes out in May. Back to Black is one star about Amy Winehouse, the singer. Kingdom of the Planet of the Apes comes out in May. Furiosa, the Mad Max saga, comes out in May.
Yeah.
Continuing that. That stars Anna Taylor-Joy and Chris Hemsworth. There's a animated Garfield movie this year, Steve.
I know. It's got Chris
Chris Pratt.
Chris, yeah. It did not look that intriguing.
Really?
I didn't think.
I grew up on the Garfield comics. I loved the Garfield comics as a kid.
I'm not a huge Chris Pratt fan.
Yeah.
And maybe that's my problem. I don't know.
Here's a funny story for y'all. When I was in sixth grade, we had to write a report on a book that we read and we really liked. And I somehow talked my teacher into letting me write mine on a Garfield comic book I had read.
Wow.
Good night, Nathaniel. Have a good one.
Night, buddy.
Thanks for everything, bud. Let's see. Just kind of scrolling through. We got Bad Boys 4 coming out in June. Inside Out 2 comes out in June the 14th. A Quiet Place Day 1 comes out June the 28th. There's another Despicable Me movie coming out.
That's number 5, I think, of that one.
They just don't stop. Twisters comes out in July 19th. Deadpool 3, July the 26th. And then, there's a bunch of more stuff coming. There's another Alien movie coming out in August.
Ooh.
Why? Alien Romulus, which I thought was from Star Trek.
Hey.
Thank you, Sparkly Pink. Appreciate it, Angie. Kraven the Hunter, another Spider-Man spinoff by Sony. So we'll see how terrible that one ends up being.
What was it?
Kraven the Hunter.
Oh, that's a Sony movie too?
Yes.
Okay, I thought I saw a preview for that. That actually looked halfway decent.
It does look halfway decent. It stars Aaron Taylor Johnson, who I kind of like.
Yeah.
Yeah. So we'll see.
I remember that kid went from like a pencil to massive overnight for the Godzilla movie.
Beetlejuice comes out in September.
Oh, man. Why? No, that would be okay. It's got Michael Keaton in it again, so.
There's an animated Transformers movie coming out in September.
Not me, Russ. I love sequels. Yes, Wicked.
Wicked? Noah. Yeah.
Wicked looks so good.
I want to see that.
Brave New Worlds is an excellent show, Stephen Kay. I agree with you on that one. I like
that. That?
Star Trek, Brave New Worlds.
Yeah.
It's a good one. October, you've got why is that? You've got Joker Folie à Deux coming out later this year.
Something like that, yeah.
Yeah. That will star Joaquin Phoenix and Lady Gaga.
Yes.
As Harley.
She's going to be awesome.
You got Venom 3 coming out later this year. Gladiator 2. Moana 2. Wicked in November. There's another Karate Kid movie.
Really?
Yeah.
Who's in that one?
It doesn't say. It just says December 13th, but there's no director or starring cast noted.
Uh-huh. It's a thought in somebody's head then for now.
Apparently. Lord of the Rings, The War of the Rohirrim.
Yes.
Comes out December 13th. Lord of the Rings movie.
That's a new movie that's coming out?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
I saw a preview for it or like a teaser or something like that. I didn't even care if it was a teaser.
It is an animated prequel.
What is?
Oh.
Lord of the Rings, War of the Rohirrim.
That's not what I saw.
Brian Cox will lend his voice to the central character.
No.
Who reigned 183 years before the events of the Two Towers.
They make this look so real. It doesn't even look like animation. And then it says, I think they just threw some stuff together to make you think it was coming out. And then it says, it's going to be animated. Like I'm looking right here. It says, the untold story behind Helm's Deep's hundreds of years before the Fateful War. It doesn't look like animation at all.
Yep.
But Wikipedia says animated fantasy.
You've got Mufasa, the Lion King.
Yes.
It comes out December. Sonic the Hedgehog 3. Yeah. So, there you go. So there's some good, I think some good movies coming out throughout the year.
They got me. I'm watching the teaser trailer for it too, and it's not animated. Oh man, none of this is animated. So many teaser, which is why you can't trust teaser trailers.
Yeah. Oh,
man. Sorry.
I think it's really going to start kicking off in a couple of weeks with Dune Part 2, and then it just kind of rolls from there.
All the movies?
Yeah. So.
Yeah, you know, I might go see a movie instead of Jeff tomorrow. That's not true. I'll go see Jeff, but if I was to go see a movie, what's playing that I haven't seen yet? So, Madam Web, which, no. And I don't really care to see Bob Marley, One Love. I do want to see Argyle.
Good night, Wendy B. Argyle is fun.
I want to see Argyle and the Beekeeper. And I still haven't seen Migration or The Boys in the Boat, which I really want to see. Oppenheimer, we're going to watch tomorrow. They're trying to put Turning Red back in.
Yes.
To try to make it actually look like it makes some money, but no.
Dennis says she's seen Argyle twice.
There's another Mean Girls movie now.
It's out. Yeah. It's out for a little while.
I haven't been paying attention.
Sparkly Bink still wants to see Wonka. I haven't seen Wonka that yet three. Either.
The next Friday, what's out? Same things. Nothing. Nothing good new. Ooh, Les Mis. That's not the movie version, though.
So the movie version, you mentioned that, Steve. The movie version is on sale on Amazon Prime right now for like $4.99. I almost bought it because everybody kept talking about how good it is.
You ever seen it?
I've never seen it.
Oh, it's so good. I love it. I want to get my tickets for Dune, but I know I got stuck going on that weekend, so I got to wait. TV shows. What else is coming out, Chris? Too many to count.
That's everything as far as movies through the year. TV shows. You've got, you'll probably dismiss this one, but X-Men 97 comes out next month on Disney Plus.
Is that animated one?
It is a continuation of the original Fox animated series.
Yeah, I won't care about that as much.
I'm excited for that. See what
putting Chris on the spot. He wasn't prepared for this tonight.
Was not. We're getting there. Ted is out now.
Ted's good. I watched it.
True Detective Night Country looks interesting to me. That's on HBO now.
And they lost me after the first season. The first season was so good. The first
True Detective?
Yeah. And it started.
I've never watched them.
So but I couldn't get through the second one. And then I tried to watch a couple episodes. And it's just not.
Yeah.
I don't know. The first one was really good, I thought. I lost interest after that.
There's some of these I've never heard of.
Do you see one called Win or Lose? It's like a little animated thing, and the team is called the Pickles.
Oh. The Pickles.
It's like a baseball team, and their name is the Pickles.
I've not seen that.
It's coming soon, so I guess it hasn't come out yet.
I think some Tracy or somebody mentioned Mr. and Mrs. Smith. That's out now. That stars Donald Glover.
Yeah.
And Maya Erskine. Looks pretty good. Tracker just started. That one premiered after the Super Bowl.
And I like it. It's good.
I wanted to watch that. I like Justin Hartley, so it looked interesting to me. Molly comes back to Joy talking about pickles. Well, you never know. Second season is worse. Is it the True Detective? Yeah, she's talking about second season was worse. Third is good. I gotta go back and watch those. Jen says, must watch TV this week is NCIS. It's David McCollum Ducky Remembrance Show. That's cool. It's weird to watch that show without him. There's a new Avatar series coming out, live action. It'll be on Netflix. I think it starts in next week. There's been some really good reviews of it. There's a new Walking Dead spinoff series coming out later this month. The Ones Who Live. It follows Rick and Michonne as they continue on their journey. There is a Shogun series coming to FX.
Yes.
Later this month, that looked really good.
Yes, I saw that they had the thing at Disney during the D23 thing.
It looks amazing as far as detail and everything. Jeff Condon said, I started watching 24 with Kiefer Sutherland.
Yes,
best series ever.
Love that.
I have never watched that series.
Oh my gosh, Chris, we should just start playing those on Sundays. There's so, I don't remember, there's like 9 seasons or something like that, but they're fantastic. I hated it towards the end when they started cramming multiple hours into one show.
Yeah.
But I'll take any 24 I would take again. I would really like them to start doing that again. It's so good.
It looked like it was really good. Let's see. Oh, there's a series coming on Apple TV Plus called Manhunt. Is the chase for Lincoln's killer.
Looks really
interesting. Yeah.
I have a thing to get 3 months free on Apple TV, so I might do my, that 3 month thing to see what I can watch on there.
Watch Hijack.
Okay.
Silo's very good. I just finished, actually, there's one more episode. I didn't realize it wasn't over. I just found these new shows. Criminal Records. I watched 7 episodes today. Realize that there's 8, and then the 8th season finale is Wednesday, so I gotta wait till Wednesday to watch the last episode. There's some really good stuff on there, and all the Fraggle Rock and Snoopy stuff is on there as well. All the Snoopies. Nuts.
Oh, April the 12th on Amazon Prime is Fallout, the live action series based on the video game that looks amazing.
I love those. Ted Lasso. Watch Ted Lasso's pretty funny too. It's over four seasons.
A lot of people love this. Bridgerton season 3 comes out May 16th.
Yes. I don't know why, but I'm hooked on that show. And Blackbird. Blackbird is so, nobody knows about Blackbird. Taron Egerton, one of my favorite actors. And the guy who plays Richard Jewell in the movie version, you would know if you saw him. He's in a couple other good things too. But that's a really, really good show. It's like 6 episodes. It's based on a true story.
Wow, there's a lot of premieres.
Justin's looking forward to season 3 of The Bad Batch that comes out on the 21st.
Nice.
I haven't watched any of those either because I didn't finish. Is it Rebels that spins off from?
I think so.
I'm not a huge fan of the animation stuff. I love cartoons, but these kind of spinoff shows that are supposed to weave into the live action stuff is meh.
I watch it sometimes because he makes me.
Trying to skip through. There's another season of the Umbrella Academy coming to Netflix August the 8th.
Nice.
I like that show.
Another season of Interview with a Vampire on AMC coming May the 12th. There is a show called Three Body Problem. And it's from David Benioff and D.B. Weiss, who did Game of Thrones.
Really?
It is stars.
Is it a spinoff, would you say?
No. It's a sci-fi epic coming to Netflix. Based on a trilogy of novels. It stars one of the guys from Game of Thrones, and I cannot think of his name. It shows me his face. It doesn't give me his name for some reason.
Who is it?
He was one of the black, the guard with Jon Snow. He was like his best friend,
The bigger guy?
Yeah, the bigger guy.
Oh, yeah, Sam.
Sam. Sam, yes, thank you. It stars him. So that's coming out. House of the Dragon season 2 is coming out, and I was hoping it would give me a date here. It's expected to debut in the summer. But no specific date. They've released a teaser trailer for that, and I've watched that a few times. The Penguin is getting his own live action series on Max, which is a spinoff from the Batman movie. That one will star was it Russell Crowe? No, Colin Farrell.
Colin Farrell,
who played the Penguin in the movie, is playing the Penguin in this series. It's sort of his rise to power after the events of the Batman movie.
Yeah.
Well, I think we can call it a night now.
Do we have to? I don't think you understand. I have nothing to do.
Yeah, I know.
Except watch more TV.
You can do that. You can work on a puzzle.
I've done 6 today. What do you, I mean... I'm out of paint. I'm out of canvases to draw too on the paint. I got one more villain I'm going to draw. Alyssa Neal, hello.
Hey, welcome in. Orphan Black Echoes is a spinoff of Orphan Black coming to AMC later this year. I'm still scrolling through series now. Agatha the Darkhold Diaries comes out later this year.
Yes. That's going to be amazing.
That looks, yeah. Ewan McGregor starring in a series, A Gentleman in Moscow.
Interesting.
It will be on Paramount Plus.
Jeff said he's going to go back to pretending to go be at work. Pretending to work.
Good night, Jeff.
We are still here because Steve is bored. That is correct.
It's true.
Steve doesn't sleep. Yep. He slept too much, so he's like wide awake.
I think Justin and I are going to watch The Sopranos.
Oh,
we better watch that. So I think we're going to start watching that.
I've never watched that either, Joy. Let me know what you think.
I watched the whole last season, which doesn't make any sense because I never watched the rest of them, but that was good, but I want to start from the beginning.
You know how it ends.
Yeah, I do.
Ooh. Joy, I'm sure Justin told you or you told him, one of the two, but what he texted me today when I come up there is going to be amazing.
Oh. I'm going to call him. I'm gonna have to call them on Monday.
Steve, one of your boys is getting another show.
Which one of boys?
Dark Matter is the name of the show. It's coming to Apple TV Plus. It is going to star Joel Edgerton. Yeah. He's going to play.
What's it called? Dark Matter.
Dark Matter. He plays Jason Deason, a physicist who is transported to an alternate version of his life. Jennifer Connelly, no stranger science fiction, plays his wife.
You said it was Joel Edgerton?
Yeah.
He's not really one of my boys.
Oh, I thought you really liked him.
No, he's in the movie Warrior with Tom Hardy. I like Tom Hardy.
Yeah.
He plays his brother. He's not bad. He's also in what's the movie I said I wanted to watch earlier? The Boys in the Boat. He's in that movie too, but
Oh yeah, Star Wars The Acolyte is supposed to come out later this year. That looks amazing. Or sounds like it's going to be amazing.
Is that a movie or a TV show?
It's going to be a series. It takes place even before the movies take place. It's set back in the High Republic days. I forgot to get my fat back. And yeah, there you go. Clicky clack.
I just want to measure my head, see how big it is.
What head size are you?
Jeez, a big one. Let me try that again. I can't.
From all that hair. Good night, Russ.
Cannot be right. Everyone.
I have a big head too, so.
It's like super. Right there. 22 and a half inches.
That's not right.
It can't be right, right? Like, I mean, look, if I go around my head to where you can see, here's the little thingy. Here's the little thingy. I grab it right there, right there. 20, that's almost 23 inches. It's like, I got a big head.
All right. Now I got to look up how to measure your hat size.
Your what?
How to measure.
Yeah, what hat size do you usually wear if you have a fitted hat?
Visors don't come fitted.
So you take that number in inches and divide it by pi and round up to the nearest eighth, and that's your cap size.
So 3.14159265. Let me see. So you take the number of inches divided by pi is what?
And then round that up to the nearest eighth.
Nearest eighth?
So like seven and five eighths or whatever.
Yeah. It's.
No worries, Debbie.
Seven and three eighths.
There you go.
If I did it right.
I'm usually a seven and I think I'm seven and five eighths.
Ah, your head's bigger than mine.
It is.
My head's kind of bigger than both y'all's.
You're making fun of mine. You're like, that can't be right. Sullivan's Crossing.
Is that the head's girth measure?
It is the girth. It's the distance of, around the head. If I move down a little bit, right, to like where I would normally wear my hat, my head gets bigger, though. It's almost 24 inches.
Oh. Yeah.
How do you measure your ring finger or your ring size?
How do you measure your ring size? You cut a thin strip of paper, wrap the paper around your finger. Make sure the paper is below the joint of your finger, close to your knuckle. Mark the spot where the paper meets and measure the distance with your ruler.
Okay, I got that because I did the same thing with an actual measure, tape measure.
Very good.
That's what it is? Your ring size is the actual distance in inches?
Your ring size then is... No. So what is your...
2 3/4.
2 3/4. So your ring size would be a 13.
Sounds about right.
There's a little chart you have to go against them. Tip tells the whole story, says Marlo.
What is it? Tip. Oh. What else can we measure, Chris, before we leave?
I feel like mine are my fingers are bigger for girls. I have mine. I have an 8, and really? all my friends have like 4s.
I don't know what mine is, and I don't have a tape measure thingy to. So I don't know.
Sounds like you need to invest in one.
I guess so.
What else can we wear? We already measured.
Like if I have a list of things you can measure, says Monorama.
If I was to measure my wrist for a watch, it's 7.5 inches. Wait a minute. It's just under 7.5 inches. What does that translate to?
Jill says, Joy, I started wearing a size 5 in my 20s. Now I'm an 8. I think my knuckles swelled.
Yeah, mine's always been big. I don't know why. Got man hands.
Stephen K says, Steve, you can measure your tiny biceps.
Tiny biceps. We get enough tape out here. Hang on a second. That ought to do it. My tiny biceps. I don't know if I can do this.
Molly's with you, Joy. Her knuckles are ginormous.
My biceps are 16.25 inches.
Look at that.
That much on a flat surface.
Wow. Wait a minute. So Neil says, why is Steve's head bigger than the tape measure? Jill Watbritt says, Neil, the tape measure has no air in it. Molly says, Nicole is being so good tonight.
She's trying.
So she did say no tiny biceps.
I saw that. Yep. She was just down here.
Yep.
That's why Steve doesn't like the Rock bicep envy. No, I'm good.
All right, we're going to call it a night.
But I got more stuff to measure.
Well, we'll save it for the next time.
Like how big my ears are, because they're huge. They are. Look how big these things are.
I don't know
are.
What that means, and it worries me.
Justin has tiny ears.
I got, look at these. They used to call me Dumbo. Oh,
that's not nice.
Ooh, if I could fly. Ooh. I'm coming off my seat. Oh, I better stop. What flavor are you drinking, Chris?
This is you can actually see it. This is the strawberry lemonade.
Squeezed lemonade, yeah.
Freshly squeezed, yeah. This one's good. I tried another strawberry lemonade. It was okay. This one's good.
I've got, I'm just drinking regular fruit punch right now.
I have to say, Steve, that I tried the circle water, but I don't like it.
You're the first person. I knew there was one out there somewhere.
I'm bad.
What kind did you try?
I tried the kind of that Chris has right now. And the strawberry, kiwi strawberry. I've not had
any of the lemonade, so I can't speak to those.
I like the freshly squeezed ones.
There are like 80-something flavors or something like that, maybe over 100 now. But there's some that I don't like. But there's some that I do a lot that I do.
Oh, wow.
I just like it.
I like the fact that you can just drink straight water through it, or the fact that you can choose 1 to 10, the strength level, and it doesn't go into the water. The water sifts through it. So,
all right. We have to talk about this.
What do we have to talk about now?
There's some new Lego.
Oh, we got new Lego. Good job, Nicole.
These are new even since last night because I was looking at this website last night.
This is how much my excitement is growing because we're talking about Lego.
Well, my wingspan's bigger than the tape measure will go. And it goes to 5 feet.
Here we go. This is the talking sorting hat.
What?
$99. It's 561 pieces.
It
looks like Harry Potter with a... Oh, you can put it on your head.
Oh, not on my big head, but...
Not on your big head, no.
That's cool.
There you go.
Wait, that says talking sorting hat. Does it talk?
It does say talking sorting hat. It doesn't look like it actually talks. I don't see talking with this. It does say it measures 9.5 inches high, 7.5 inches in diameter.
Ooh, that was close. It's only this tall. That's it.
The display stand features Gryffindor, Slytherin, Hufflepuff, and Ravenclaw crest decorations, and Harry wearing the sorting hat.
Nice.
Anything. Then there's this. This is the forest animals, the red fox. It's one of those 3-in-1, So there's him standing. There's an owl. And there's a squirrel.
Yay. Are the owl and the squirrel as big as the fox?
I don't know. It's 667 pieces. The features the buildable owls standing over 7 inches tall. So that must be the tallest of the three, if that's the height of that one. And then last but not least, Steve, I don't know if you saw this or not, but here you go. It's the Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs cottage.
I've not seen that.
$219.99.
How big is this?
It comes with the cottage. It comes with her glass coffin that she's sleeps in. All seven dwarfs, the prince, and the witch.
The old hag.
This is 2,228 pieces.
How big is it?
It is, where's my specs? Here we go. It measures over 8 inches high, 14 inches wide, and 7.5 inches deep.
Yeah, it's not bad.
There's a better look at your minifigs.
That's probably, if I had to guess, I would have assumed that would have been about 149, 169, somewhere in there. But maybe you're paying for all the minifigs and the Disney name. I don't know. Oh, wow. I like the minifigs. That's one I might have to have.
That's it, Molly. 7.5 inches deep. Yep. That's yep. I could say something, but I'm not going to. So
the price is probably correct for that. I mean, that's based on Lego, based on Disney. That's probably
based on Disney licensing. It's not bad.
Especially since you get 8 characters. What do you get? Now you get 9 characters. No, so 8, 9, 10 characters.
Yeah.
So. And the detail on the cottage is pretty cool.
It is. Yep. So there you go. That comes out March the 4th.
Does this remind you of a lightsaber?
Steve Browning wants to know if you could measure your neck.
I can, but I think they just want me to squeeze my neck really hard. So.
Nicole says she is being good.
He's trying.
All right. Love y'all. Thank you so much for the donations. Thank you for
13 minutes away from 1 o'clock.
All the fun tonight.
I refuse to say goodbye.
Huh?
I refuse to say goodbye.
I'll say goodbye for both of us. I love you all. We'll see you back tomorrow night for Oppenheimer.
Hello, everybody, for part two. Hello for part two.
Take care. Be sure to check out Jeff in the morning over at Animal Kingdom. Make sure he doesn't float away with all the animals. And Triple C's tomorrow night over on Pete's channel at 6 o'clock with Molly and Snickerdoodle and friends. And we'll see you back here tomorrow night, 8 o'clock special time.
It's 8 fingers.
8 o'clock for Oppenheimer. Love you all. We'll see you soon. Take care. Thank you again so much. And
block the water.
Have a blessed one.